the important part of making characters, having fun. So we're going to see a Vega Mirror match. Much as we like to talk about three frame jab this, three frame jab that.
Three frame stand short.
With Vega, well, it is stand light kick.
That he does have a three frame jab too, but I think it's only, yeah, only clawless.
What? Oh, yeah. All right, so we're going to go right into it here. L Alex is... Shit, I'm not sure which color it is who.
I guess we'll find out. I think the right is L Alex, because I think he likes to use that color.
Just wait, just wait, just wait.
Not right now, but...
Yeah, it was
yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah, that's the color he likes to use.
What am I doing here? Projector. All right, there we go. All right, so Valteria off to a pretty, has a pretty good life lead.
Yeah, all right, throw.
Oh, never mind, Alex is the one with the life lead. If
no, no, it's the other way around.
Alex is green, green.
Yeah.
Alex is green?
Yeah. So Valteria just won the first round.
Wait. Oh, you're talking about the sash. I'm looking at the pants color.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. Now we're into top of the shop here. So L Alex wearing the black pants, Valteria in the teal. Wait, but if that's true, L Alex took the first round or first game then.
No.
First round.
L Alex is player two. I said that like three times.
Bitch, no you didn't. I don't want to hear that.
Oh, no conversion off of that. Could have potentially taken the round with that.
Good mix-ups in the corner. All right, now we're in commentary mode. We've got it updated, blah, 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 all that stuff.
So Valteria going to take the first game.
So I'm not really sure what L Alex wants to look for in this mirror match. Other than it's really going to have to come down to ground game, I feel.
Yeah, I think he's just going to want to chill and wait for Valteria to, like, do something unsafe, because he's pretty buttonsy.
Yeah.
And, like, eventually he will just overextend.
All right, so Alex going to Cammy. Probably a better choice when it comes to these two players anyways.
Right.
Valteria does do a lot of streaming, so I've got to imagine his online experience with Cammy is intact. So it'll be basically come down to what can L Alex kind of get away with in this scenario.
Yeah.
A lot of. I mean, you really want to try to check. The problem, where Vega wants to stand in this matchup is he wants to stand just on the tip of the claw until Cammy can prove that she can get in.
Right.
Cammy's buttons, namely her low forward, are really good.
Ooh, yeah, and that forward wrap. Forward roundhouse is minus two, excuse me. Nice whiff punish.
Yeah, I think of Cammy's forward roundhouse, the double knees, as a better solar plexus.
Yeah.
As far as frames go.
Yeah, it's definitely faster. As far as like frame advantage, it's the same.
Now, if I'm Valteria right now and I got that free dive in without a challenge, I would just keep doing it.
Yeah. Ooh, nice V reversal.
That is the most controversial V reversal on the tongues of top players, because they all want to figure out how to punish it because it's minus eight, but you can't set the dummy to do V reversal.
Oh, the Cammy one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because people like explicitly want to try to figure out how to punish that V reversal.
Well, it's minus eight if she doesn't hit you.
Right.
So if she doesn't cross up.
Right.
It's minus eight.
So basically, where Valteria wants
to
be.
A little too slow on the punish. Got to buffer that while the roll's still going on.
Yeah.
Even though it is pretty negative.
Nice. Low four or low strong.
No anti-air.
Yeah. Cammy's got a great DP.
Yeah, and even without that, she also has stand roundhouse and back strong.
Back me, yeah. Back strong is really good. Is it four frames?
I'm not sure. Oh wow. Threw him out of the spin knuckle. I didn't know that was throwable.
All right. Wake up super. L Alex laughing to himself about it. The classic L Alex, like he's just going to do it and laugh. But he's in a good position right now.
Yeah.
Valteria trying to make a comeback here. Oh,
wow, that should have been game.
Well, he's got a chance right here.
L Alex just hanging on to this V trigger.
He's not going to. Oh, my goodness.
I really want to see him just cancel into this V trigger. He's not using it at all.
Yeah, he was fishing right there for a little bit of frame advantage, just basically being like, I'm going to guarantee V plus on this. I'm going to push a button afterwards and beat you up. trying to get him with some of the hooligan shenanigans.
Yeah. Vega can't really do a ton about that either, really.
Just hit it on the way in?
Wow. Well, yeah, he can, but he just doesn't have the greatest anti-airs even in this game.
So L. Alex definitely lacking in the hit confirm department. Basically, if he sees that low forward block, hit, whatever, he's going to go for the spiral arrow. Oh,
ooh, no punish on the wake up uppercut.
Yeah, you want to? I think Vega wants to look for the double roundhouse combos, kind of like Ryu, crush ooh. Counter damage.
I saw what I like what L. Alex was going for there, but he dropped the combo. Yeah, and Valteria is a pretty big fan of that overhead on his opponent's wake up. It's not a true meaty though. You can totally blow that up.
Right. But usually overheads like that, you're just trying to guess, right?
Yeah.
Yep, gonna be enough damage.
Yeah, nice solid punish from L. Alex.
So that basically you have to treat Cammy with a loaded V trigger is basically she has another critical R ready to go.
Pretty much.
Because
it's
a lot of damage really fast.
Yeah. And if she just gives it up after the spiral arrow, she gets a free mix up on your wake up.
Right.
Which is what K-Bread actually recommends. You should always save the meter for the mix-up unless you're going to kill.
Hmm, I see. That's pretty smart. Finds a throw. What's the next one? Oh, nice.
Ooh, yeah.
That's the only time that the cross-up hooligan has worked, or excuse me, spin knuckle has worked. Very close to stun here, trying to find his way in. Valtteri finds an opening out.
Yeah, and again, going for that untrue meaty.
It's really just kind of a tale of buttons right now. Cammy, with Claw off Vega, Cammy's got a slight advantage in the range game and much more explosive damage for less effort.
Sure.
Vega's gonna kind of poke away. Vega's gonna kind of poke away at you, but without that Claw and out, without a way to train you to dash in and get a command grab or anything like that, gonna be a kind of a harder time for Vega to try to come back. And Cammy can kind of just waddle back and forth, low forward, spiral arrow.
Yeah, nice throw. Ooh, ballsy dash up. Cammy is actually neutral after her throw. Does not get a setup off of that. So that dash puts him minus Valtteria. Fortunately not recognizing that, not challenging with anything.
Nice confirm off the same roundhouse. Looking for more damage here. Here's where the big mix-ups are. Close to stun. Lines one. Going to be in
the edge.
Kind of one of those situations where you're either dead or you're going to be stunned.
Right.
See, it never fails, dude. They can talk anywhere else in the entire area. They want to talk right behind the stream setup.
Exactly. It's like never.
Never fails.
It's our curse, man.
It's an eternal curse.
Oh, can definitely punish that forward fierce. Especially that close.
Now, Vega can still space his roundhouse and make it safe, right?
I think so, yeah. Ooh, nice. No super, though. Hangs on to it.
Man, the advice that I would want to give Valtteria, if this was like a big tournament, you know, in between matches, be like, look, this guy is going to go for a combo no matter what. Just block and punish. Be patient.
Now, Alex expecting the overhead, but it doesn't come.
All right, Valtteria trying to close it out here. Nice break. Oh, he's trying to super? Maybe? There it is.
Yeah.
Rip. All right, so Valtteria gonna pick it up. All right, so next on stream, I need... Next on stream, Fokker and No Alias. After that, Chody Chobin and Filthy Clam Trap. They're already playing. After that, Jessarugi and Old Boy. All right, guys. Again, thanks for watching Top in the Shop. Got a little bit of a later start, but just wanted to make sure everybody's just hanging out. Make sure everybody got here on time.
So I'm interested to see who No Alias picks here. I know he's been a Nash main for a little bit, but he's been playing a lot of Ken lately. So we could see the Ken come out.
Yeah, I think Nash or Ken both do pretty well in the Birdie Nash. What's up? Oh, yeah, I'll jump in with my matches already. I was going to do some commentary for a little bit. I think Nash and Birdie are Nash and Ken are both good matchups against Birdie. Where I was trying to go with that.
Right.
Blah, blah, blah. So, I'm not really sure. I just haven't gotten to see Jeremy Yon play enough to you know, say whether or not his Nash or his Ken is better.
Right.
There's always hints during the match when he plays Ken, for example, where he'll go for Nash-esque punishes, but they, because of the muscle memory involved,
sure,
that he just doesn't have yet with Ken. And then there's been some times when he switched back to Nash where he goes for like weird Ken kind of stuff. I don't know. Kind of the internal struggle from when you switch back and forth between two characters like that.
Right.
But we know Fokra for sure will be going to Birdie. And Fokra, a grappling pro from old in Street Fighter 4, played Geef pretty much exclusively. And had a lot of success here in Kansas City with that Zangief play. Jeremy Yan played Cammy. Fei Long, was it Fei Long towards the end of Ultra? So here we go. It looks like the... Okay, the names are switched.
No, they should be right.
Yeah, I got it.
Oh, okay.
I had it originally set up with No Alias, the second player.
Oh, okay.
So things you're going to look for here. Nash is probably going to start the game out with some early zoning attempts using the space and the sonic booms, what have you, and the medium kick scythe to try to keep Birdie out.
Right.
Birdie not going to blow you up in a couple hits. It's going to be a war of attrition for Birdie. He's going to chip away at you. He's going to get those medium kicks, those stand around houses, things like that. Nash kind of in the same way, barring a crush counter combo.
Right.
Big jump in, no medium punch from Birdie. One of the best anti-airs, bar none, in the game. Now that dive, that's something you really want to pay attention to. I think it's not so much anymore, but as the game has evolved, that was a move that was a big deer in headlights kind of move, right, where you just kind of let it happen and you got scooped.
Sure.
So you can get around that move by just normals.
No anti-air attempt from No Alias.
Yeah, no, neither one of them. Both players are seem hesitant. Maybe they're just not uncomfortable with the spacing looking for anti-airs right now. They're doing a lot of air-to-air. Trying to go in for the EX moonsault. Good idea.
Ooh. Okay, gets the throw.
Punish. Nope. You can still... I don't know if Nash has got any reversal buttons to get that. That one, though, it's got to be punished.
Yeah. Yeah, I think he was afraid to challenge because of the can, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I could be right. V-reversal would have been a good idea for Nash just to get away from Ken.
Sure.
Unless for some reason in that scenario, the Ken was, like, meaty, like, which I guess could have been a thing.
Yeah, well, it doesn't matter if he does V-reversal because it's hit invincible.
Oh, okay.
It has to be thrown.
Dash under? Nope, stays in front.
Well, I don't know if it's hit invincible, actually.
No, because you can meaty it.
Yeah, you can meaty it, but... Like, well, you have to be in block stun to be reversal. So, like, if you do something, you have to do something that recovers fast enough to throw him out of it to counter the V reversal.
Right. I'm just talking about the scenarios when he was in block stun from the EX bullhorn.
Right. Yeah.
Birdie on a full super here. Probably not going to see. Going to opt to use that bar for armored moves to help you get through projectiles, but doesn't really need it right now. Trying to dash forward. Fokra is very good. It's hard to throw Fokra. He's very intuitive on knowing when to press buttons. Missing another anti-air there. Yan opts for the... I'll drop a combo on purpose to try to convince you to hold down back and then rush in for a throw, and Fokra not biting on it. So Fokra up one game.
Right. Yan looking very pensive about that game.
Yeah, it was a couple things where he was just like, well, I really feel like the EX... The first one, canceled by the horn, by the V-reversal, not punishable by Nash anyways in that situation. And then he was very hesitant to do it the second one. Might be a question mark over his head. Chain just out of range. Caffeine on the board. Nice. I like Fokra using the can and the... I still want to call that the criminal, the knuckle.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's charged in the same fashion.
Yeah, the zonk.
Yeah, zonk knuckle.
I don't even remember what it's actually called for Birdie. I still call it zonk.
Wow, that was weird. Hitbox is like changed around.
Yeah.
This one square range right here is really where Fokra is doing well. I mean, this is just where Birdie beats you up. Kind of like Chun-Li in a sense. He's got the same range with buttons.
Right.
But that's all he's got, though. Barring a EX move into V trigger into more EX move, Birdie really, like I say, doesn't have a lot of burst damage. It just beats you up at that range. Jan with the mix-ups right now. Overhead, he defines a throw. Hold him in the corner. No
Oh, nice.
No anti-airs from both sides still.
Yeah.
It's okay. They're making it work. They're making it work. Chain fake out over the top.
Goes over and yeah.
Man, that jump, I think that's jump medium punch from Birdie, the horizontal.
Yeah, the one where it hits on both sides.
Excellent use of V-trigger right there to get out. Doesn't want to deal with the mix-up. Has him in the corner now. Don't want to let him out. Already looking for a way, though. Oh, I mean, look, this is just tit for tat. Just little chunks.
Yeah. All right. Foker with a pretty comfortable life lead right now, too, but... Oh, is this going to get him? Yeah.
Gigantic forward hitbox on that critical hard by Nash.
Gonna need one more though.
Yep.
Oh, nice patience from Jeremy Young.
Oh no, but no punish. Oh, 30 seconds to play. Both players trying to be extremely patient right here. Oh, it finds the overhead. Good idea on. I mean, there are some good looks of patience on both sides of that. All right, guys, we'll get your next match going here. Valteria.
Oh, my bad, dude.
Jesse Ruby, old boy, on stream, please.
They're playing off.
Oh. Okay, hold on. Let me get caught up in the bracket. I need Watson
Chan and Time Pants.
All right. All right, guys. Joining me now on commentary, Mr. Ray Sean, RTY. Unless Watson broke my fucking headset and then you go into rage mode.
Just on backwards. What's up, guys? Up next, we're going to have either a Ryu mirror match, Ken Ryu. Time Pants making his appearance. First time we've seen him in a long time. It's been a couple months since he's been here.
Yes, sir.
Watson Chan, a weekly.
So you guys might see every time the players go back to the sign-in, the login screen on the PlayStation, you see my face. That's my face. That's how I look all the time.
So we don't need
I'm just
him.
Always, I'm just always like, I just always got this face of like, man, I'm over this.
So that way we don't need him on commentator cam because you just know what face he's
Yeah, you see my face enough. You can call me asshole.
There
it is.
So cute.
Look at that. I'm just over it. What do you think about Daigo's statement about Street Fighter V only being alive in Japan because of the CPT money?
Dude, it's probably true.
Being the arcade being the biggest factor, that there's no arcade.
Yeah, for sure. The Street arcade plays... I'm sorry? Yeah. Arcades obviously was the biggest thing in Japan when it came to Ultra. If you guys watch any of the Topanga late at night, yep. They were playing on arcade or, you know, stuff like that. So they don't have that for this game. So that's one thing that plays a big factor. The part of it where I can see is that Japan is a very technical scene when it comes to fighting games, right?
Yep.
And they're the ones figuring out all this tech, but there's not that much tech for them to figure out.
Right.
So I'm sure that plays a big part in it, and they realize that this game is so simple that maybe they just don't get a lot of pleasure out of it.
Yep.
So
pretty much the general consensus is they either will go back to Street Fighter 4 or Third Strike, or they will go just hard all switch to Guilty Gear.
Yeah, which is what you're seeing a lot of scenes doing. St. Louis is actually going to Guilty Gear.
Yeah.
Casamilco's been playing a lot of Guilty Gear. Just made grand finals at the Thailand tournament.
Yeah.
And Guilty Gear is a really fun game. At the same time, Street Fighter's where the money's at, and that's exactly what I agree that what Daigo said. That's where they're staying there. So, anyways, back to the match: Time Pants versus Watson Chan. We got Watson Chan with the sexy Ryu alt.
Yes, Time Pants in the hyper fighting white Ryu.
Nice counter hit confirmed there from Watson Chan.
Yeah, kind of a visual reaction there from Time Pants. Like, what? That works?
Yeah.
So Watson gonna be definitely comfortable in this matchup. Double parry, catches the dash on the way.
Wow, yo.
Beat him up button.
He just double parried?
Oh yeah.
Level up Watson, that's what I'm talking about.
No. I'll say, yo, Watson got those, and then I look all the way across the room and the sensei guy is saying that he's like, he ain't got those.
It's quiet, so
yeah.
He ain't got those.
He ain't got those. I'm like, what?
So that's the sensei guy.
Yeah, Blake is here as well. You'll see him winner's side.
Yeah, no anti-air there on that jump light kick. It's very risky. If you're not going to DP, don't do anything.
At this point, Watson just kind of feeling out what his opponent is and is not capable of. Watson, though, not a very jumpy player to begin with, so not going to see a lot of disrespect in that way.
Oh, that's going to come, yeah. So for you guys who don't know why that really hit, V-trigger activations have a crap ton of startup frames. And if you're doing them in between a block string or a fireball or a stomp or something's coming your way,
you're going
to get hit by it. So that's why that worked there.
It's confusing, or it's confusing to look at because it stops time.
Right.
So you think, oh, I'm going to be able to V-trigger in the middle of this combo, kind of like a combo breaker.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's a combo breaker, or like you got your burst in other games and stuff like that. That's what you kind of vision it as, but that's not what it is.
Right. So what Time Pants needs to do, he needs to establish some faucet of the Ryu game, be it the ground game, a zoning game, or a up-in-your-face beat-em-up style kind of game.
Yep.
And right now, Watson is just kind of standing at the ranges where that's just not going to be a thing. We're kind of getting a little bit of like, oh, you can parry? Oh, I can parry better than you, you know? It's
yeah. Very nice cross-up DP there from, oh, does he get the conversion? No, he doesn't.
That's a Street Fighter 4 combo.
Yeah, it's definitely a Street Fighter 4.
Good idea.
Watch the overhead. Very nice, dude. What's the mix-up? Okay, so at this point, I'm sure Watson Chan is noticing that he's pressing buttons off the solar plexus. He can finally realize that his opponent is aware that that's negative 2 in this game, so expect the DP off of the solar plexus here anytime soon. Very nice confirm here from Watson Chan. Gonna take that round.
That is max range standard house, dude. Too. That wasn't given. You had to realize. I would have abandoned that combo. I would have been like, nah, this is gonna work. I'm gonna stop at 1 right
now. Ooh, very nice meter build DP there.
Yep.
Just so you guys know. That is a meter build.
Big damage incoming.
Oh, very nice punish there. Oh, yep, sweet punish on that sweep there.
Yep, all the sweeps in this game, you want to be looking to punish them. They are pretty much free in Street Fighter 4. Oh no! Oh,
yep, that's gonna be the set.
Yeah, he could have blocked that.
Yep.
Just for the exact same reasons we just talked about, that you do that between a move like that, you're gonna eat it in full.
Yep. And if anything, if you're gonna do anything that's not block, B reversal is your only other option. So V trigger is not the answer there. And actually, in certain situations, like when you're playing against lore, which I don't know why I've never thought of it this way, V reversing is very good. Get you out of a lot of stuff you shouldn't be in.
Against Laura?
Yeah.
Yeah, I treat Laura and Mika the same way, man.
Oh, yeah. So I was actually talking with... Yeah.
Valteria on stream, please.
It's interesting though, because Balrog tweeted, PR Balrog tweeted, and we kind of had a conversation about it. He's been playing a lot of Nicali without V trigger, just to figure out the character. Like playing Nicali without V trigger is totally different than playing with him with V trigger.
Yeah.
And he said he was getting good results. And we decided on talked on what matchups we think that would apply to playing Nicali without V trigger, and to keep that V reverse. And we both agreed, Laura is a must. Dawson. It depends on the Dawson you're playing. If you're playing a teleport happy Dawson, you want that V trigger to get your meaties down and stuff like that. If you're playing a limb heavy Dawson, it's
what? Do I mind if you use it? Go for it.
Okay.
So if you're playing a limb heavy Dawson. Playing a limb heavy Dawson, we decided that maybe it's better to keep your V trigger. It all depends on that matchup, but we did for sure Laura, Bison, Mika, and that's about it. That you just want to play regular Nicali on. So the meta is definitely advancing when it comes to this V trigger, V reversal stuff. It's very interesting. I think a Buki is gonna up that meta so hard. I think we're gonna end up V reversing almost everything we can. So up next, Watson Chan and...
Nope, well, Carlton Banks and Valteria.
Carlton Banks and Valteria. Yeah.
Is this a butt?
Yeah, butt check.
Okay.
All right.
I was confused because we know Valteria mains Vega. Carlton Banks also can play Vega somewhat.
But Valteria is strictly Vega.
Yeah.
So...
All right, so a little bit old school button check. So if you guys aren't familiar with what a button check is or what that means, it's not just two players mashing a bunch of random buttons. It's kind of a throwback to the old school arcade day when you have hundreds of people going through your arcade. Some of them were practiced masters at the game. Others were just kids hitting buttons just to hit buttons. So you did a button check to make sure all your punches work, all your kicks work, the stick wiggled both ways, sideways and left. Because you've been to an arcade, you've probably been... You probably have experienced the wow, player one side can't do up back. That's neat.
So
button checks from the old game more. It was just custom controller configuration, so on and so forth.
Nowadays, when you go to arcade, you definitely have to button check, because 78% of the time, those buttons aren't working.
Does my anti-air jab work?
Especially when you are playing Balrog in Championship Edition. All
right, so... Vega is going to have a natural advantage on the ground, just with a little bit more range than Alex. That being said, Alex can fight back with that crouch medium punch of his own. He's got incredible range and active frames.
So talking with Fire Team, where I think Alex would actually have the advantage on is when he gets a knockdown. So right here in that situation we just saw, Vega has no options after a hard knockdown. He doesn't get a meaty setup, whereas Alex... He gets a full setup into a mix-up and whatnot that he has to worry about. And Carlton Bakes doesn't have to worry about that with Vega. So that's going to play a big part in this matchup.
So meaty, when we're talking about meaty setup, it is when the opponent is on the ground and you do a button or an action to where no matter what happens, the opponent must block. If they do not block, they get hit by whatever action you did.
Yeah, if they press a button and it's a heavy button, you're getting crush countered.
Yeah, it plays into the offense of how Street Fighter V is generally built around.
Yep. Meaties are a huge part of set play.
Yeah, meaties were not super important in Street Fighter 4, but in this game, they are definitely part of it. All warmed up, more damage, just going to go for the corner carry. Look for the quick rise there, because that was a meaty setup. Yeah. So, had Valteria instantly woke up and did not block, you would have got hit by that kick no matter what.
Yep.
That is what a meaty is about. Classically, think about it this way. If you're playing Ryu, you knock them down, and you throw the fireball, and they have to block the fireball, otherwise they take the damage.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That's the classic meaty.
Yep.
That's one I always use for the example.
That's actually a great example. A lot of that's a lot of what Guiles and Ashes do nowadays. Ryu not so much, but a lot of Guiles and Ashes bank off that meaty Sonic Boom.
Yeah, dude, because Guile and Ash don't have buttons that beat you up and take your girlfriend the way Ryu does, man. That meaty punch, dude, you get clocked by that, you're losing your girlfriend. I guarantee it.
Yeah.
I guarantee it.
Or meaty solar plexus.
Yeah.
Good luck. GG's.
Yeah, that's just putting you in a coffin. It doesn't. Yeah. Wow, great anti-air off the wall dive.
Yeah, so as you mentioned earlier, Carlton Banks, very familiar. He plays a little bit of a Vega, so I'm sure he familiarizes himself with situations.
Vega, to be honest, hasn't changed a whole lot in previous iterations of Street Fighter, period. Mm. It's just the ranges and options he has in some of the same scenarios.
Very good V reversal.
What is what you want to look for.
So we're seeing a little bit of adaptation there from Valteria with that V reversal off that forward, the heavy punch, the lariat there. It is +3. Yep. And he got tired of dealing with that mix-up, so he V reversaled out of it. That was really good.
Kind of one of the downfalls of Vega, though, is the V reversal always moves him back towards the corner.
His
and that sucks.
And his V reversal, when it comes to like punishing with it, is only good in the corner.
Yeah.
So it's an iffy V reversal, but it's in that situation it was really good. I liked it there.
It's one of the weaknesses of the character overall, is what Japan said, but just an overall not strong V reversal.
Yeah. You hear Japan say he doesn't do enough damage and his V reversal is weak.
I think his damage is really good.
I think his damage is just fine, but Japan seems to think otherwise.
It was better in the betas.
He was actually broken.
Yeah, Grand Wolf was blowing people up with those before the launches. Because it would be like roll, button, more damage, command grab, and it was just like, what?
Yeah, he was actually broken in the beta.
He was good. So both characters here on a full stick of super.
Not, that's confirmed. Shit. No. He punished the slide, or he got a slide punish, but he didn't do anything other than a crouch medium punch. But it's not going to come back to haunt him, as he's going to take that set 2-0. Carlton Bakes, as you guys don't know, I can't even remember what he entered as last week, but he was Lone Wolf. He was our second place. Second place last week. Lost to Fire Team in Grand Finals. Fire Team not entering this week. He is here.
Watson Chan and Boker on stream, please.
He's just being a good guy and not trying to take our money.
Valteria and Old Boy elsewhere, please.
Every time I get my stick back from Jeremy on, something about it is messed up.
Yo, my bad, Robbie. I broke all 7 of your buttons.
It's not nothing. It's nothing like that. It's the twist tie that keeps my cable is just gone. Or it wasn't coiled up properly inside the box.
To be fair, dude, I hate coiling those things up.
I am a broadcast technician at heart, man. Countercoiling is in my blood, so I keep my cables, try to keep them looking nice.
Yo,
this orange extension cord back here, though, is older than everybody in this room, so that doesn't count. I don't hold that.
Yo, tell Kyle I'll buy his VLX if he lowers that price. God damn.
What, 250?
Dude, 300.
It's like brand new, and it has lights in it.
I don't want the lights, dog.
Think
Take
about
the
that. You're not
out.
Paying for shipping, though.
I don't want
You're
the
not
lights.
Paying for shipping, though.
Fuck that, dude. Oh, That's a used stick. You're charging me full price for that, dog.
It's pretty clean. It is barely used, in my opinion.
$250 and I'll sell it, dog. $250 and I'll get it. If you guys don't know, I'm a stick whore.
Only I get the 250 VLX.
You know, I'm a stick whore. This is my current stick. This is a round one TE. I got a TE2. I got a custom stick, dog. But I just love sticks.
Like when I see like pro players, like Justin Wong, they like unplug their stick and they wrap the cord around the stick.
Does that make you cringe?
I want
to
bomb it.
Because I do it to mine all the time.
Want to bomb it?
Especially to this crappy STE because the doors suck in it. Shout out to stick doors being very bad.
Oh yeah, stick doors are always bad. But well, it's not bad. We got Birdie and Ryu on stage here in the dance ring.
Yep, we haven't seen Russia. Poker here in a while.
Well, these guys have played a bunch of casuals. Watson playing a Ken.
Okay. So, Birdie. Ooh, very nice. Gonna get. Ooh.
Wow. Real karate here.
Wow, Watson-chan. Very nice there.
That's one thing about Fokra. He's always going to try to challenge you with a button between stuff. So we saw him. You know, he tried to go for the charge-up fireball stuff, and he got jabbed for it. Man, the placement of that banana. Oh, wow. Recycling day. Take the trash out. No DP. Oh, that crouch medium punch? That was a DP.
Yeah.
That was a DP.
Well, it could be a general anti-air, though, too. I see Watson-chan try to do crouch medium punch sometimes. Is it accidental?
I think it was accidental, because I think he's moving forward and he hit that crash medium punch and Birdie was in the air.
Yeah. So Birdie, very hard. You have to DP his anti-airs because the jump ins are so weird. He's going to get a full combo punish off that. And another one, but he just goes for the simple. That banana plays such a big factor in this matchup, or in general, every matchup. Birdie just gets to stand behind it and turtle for a little bit.
I think Ryu, the only projectile character in the game that can...
contest with
punish chain on block with reversal hard punch fireball.
Nikali can, well, I guess it's not a projectile. I was gonna say disc guidance.
Right. Oh, okay. Like that makes sense because he moves forward so fast.
Oh, very nice.
See, so Watson trying to answer the dive in with the neutral jump, which is not a bad idea, but you're usually not gonna get. No, committed.
Wow, that DP.
Do it with your heart. Finds it.
Yeah.
Okay.
So. I've never seen a conversion off of a jump in
jump
medium
strong?
Punch. Yeah.
Yeah, dude. That's news to me, man. Jump strong has always been a big fat combo button, though. It's like whatever you hit jump strong, you're going to get something after it.
Yeah.
Classic way to confirm into Ultra 1 in Street Fighter 4 days.
Very nice fireball game from Watson-chan we're seeing right here in this neutral.
Man, you talk about this neutral. Watson doing a lot of neutral jumps as he's trying. He is so scared of the Birdie command grab because he knows Fokra is a grappler at heart. He's gonna find a way in.
Mm-hmm.
Cancel. This is the big damage I'm talking about when it comes to Birdie. That's about as big as you're gonna see.
Fireball. No. Wow. He just does it into that command grab. That's gonna be some nice damage. And
wow, Fokra knew. He turned around.
Oh shit, dude, that does so much damage.
What does? The command grab?
Yeah. Well, I mean, to be fair, the command grab, the range on it is rough. So when it works, it should do a decent amount of damage, but I think it does too much damage.
Round one. That does all right.
EX, though.
GG's. Burn the meter. You got to burn that reset.
Oh, very nice. He was just sitting there with a chain. Watson able to sweep, realize it really fast. Punish. He gets something.
Wow, Ryu in brawl mode right now.
Yeah, I feel like you have to be. When you get Birdie into the corner, that's when it's your game.
Oh, he's a grappler, but he is the grappler that you want to rush down. And normally, in all other Street Fighter logic, grappler means you keep them out. You do not want to rush them down, but Birdie is not that. You can't really get in there.
What Watson has to watch out, though, is Birdie does have meter, and he does have a one-frame armor. So he has to be very aware of that. He gets the solar plexus meaty, though, and it's not a factor in that round. Watson-chan showing some sign of life.
Yeah.
Chachi won.
Okay. Birdie actually gets up a frame slower than the rest of the cast, so that he's that much more of a susceptible target to meaties. Okay, watch the next time they go air-to-air right there. Watson stayed in front last time. This is where it's hard for Birdie.
Oh, yeah. Wake up, Super.
Skip to my loot, baby.
Like I said, there's several options. Fokra, obviously, not names are switched, by the way, I just noticed that. But Fokra not having those one-frame armor super cancels that
I don't
have been
expect,
recently discovered.
I mean, I don't think they're super practical. I think it's a good tool to have in your back pocket.
Oh, very nice. He was able to get the read there.
No. That's what I'm saying, though. This is how Birdie fights. Anybody else in the game is going to get a big deal off that punish sweep. Okay, the overhead, that's a good option.
That air-to-air, he stayed in front again.
Ooh. Oh, no, didn't get the second hit.
Yeah, only one hit there. Punish, good. Very good round there from Watson Chan. Going to take that 1-1 with Fokra. He's doing very good. Solid punishes on those that armored move there, that forward heavy punch it is. -7 on block.
Watson looking a little bit rusty early on. Dropped some combos, but really managed to lock it in here. 1-1.
Oh, man, I got to fight Mika next.
You don't got to fight Mika. You got to fight the Mika.
Going to take you for a ride. Dun, 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 dun.
Big damage. Speaking of rides right now. Almost worked out better. He got hit by the cannon in that situation.
Yeah, so I've definitely found in my time labbing this match in certain situations, it's a lot better taking the can. Because you got to worry about command grab afterwards. You take the can, the command grab is going to whiff. So.
Yeah, and like Birdie's not, he doesn't get a juggle off of it or anything.
Nope.
So it's not like he's going to like, you know, trip on the. Either stun, or I'm sorry, dizzy, or damage right there.
Yeah, B reversal gets him out of the stun situation.
Fokra on the march.
Ooh,
wow.
Quick rise.
That was dirty.
Oh, nice. Jump back OS there from Watson Chan.
Nice low forward.
Yeah, so you guys at home, if you guys see somebody do jump back light kick, it's not scrubby, I promise. It's OS. So if they grab, he's going to tech the grab. Meaties, he's going to jump back.
So I think it's just block.
It's just block.
It's just block.
If you delay meaties, it's a jump back. So
and you just get knocked out of it.
Yeah.
So it's not that big of a deal. Wow. Speaking of, all right, so back in the match here, Birdie had a gigantic life lead.
Ooh.
And Birdie got a lot of health, so Ryu got quite the wall to climb. Man, cult flu season in effect right here.
Yeah, you know what I see? I see Fokra does not use V-trigger at all. That's going to be the round.
All right.
He loves that V-reversal.
Birdie, or Fokra, I should say, three jump-ins back-to-back, and not a single one of them anti-aired. This could be the exploit that Fokra needs to seal this game.
Yep. Like I said, if you're gonna hit Birdie out of the air, you have to DP.
Ken actually
He went for the mix-up.
Ken actually has to anti-air with a heavy punch DP, which is weird because of the way that Birdie's hitboxing.
Yeah, that's nothing. We're seeing so many missed anti-airs.
Yeah.
He's gonna DP after the jump in.
You get one back.
Oh, solar plexus breaks armor. Ooh, nice neutral jump. Oh, the second hit of that jump strong connected. Nothing off of it. He just walks under the jump in.
Yeah, man. No, not even. I mean, Watson knows what we gotta do, but this is
so much damage. So what Watson has to notice is after every jump in that doesn't get anti-aired. Oh, nice jump back. Fokra is always V-reversaling.
He's looking for a light kick Tatsu right
here. Oh, you know, he should have supered that.
Oh, that would have been great. It would have killed him, too.
Yeah, it would have won.
One button is all Fokra needs to win right here. It's very dangerous at this range, too. It's very hard. Ryu cannot fight this.
No, yeah, that stand medium kick is so good. That's his footsie tool, and it is his foot in your mouth. And it is really good.
Anti-air.
A lot of things, we saw a lot of matchup knowledge from Watson Chan. One thing that would have won in the round we didn't see. Missed anti-airs, but we'll get it going. Up next, we have Robbie B. Versus
against
Filthy Clam Trap.
That'll be Thor, yeah.
Thor, so we're going to have another Birdie. And
all right, I'm going to leave you guys in the capable hands of Fireteam and RTY. Again, thank you so much for watching Top from the Shop, located here at Alamo Draft House in Kansas City. Check them out at Facebook/AlamoDraftHouseKC. Coming up next, myself and Thor. Stay tuned.
Damn. Yo, let me see what's up with chat. If chat's even alive. Chat, you alive? Damn, Rip. Yo, Zevran, my dude. Yo, let me know if you want to come see this this alien, dog. I am.
All right, what's up, guys?
I got the best alien in Kansas City, dog. Ah, shit, nobody plays Mortal Kombat.
Dude. Yeah, I don't know.
So
once again, losing with the correct read.
So
it's never happened to me as much as it has in this game.
So, anti-air.
It's like not worth it to go for the risk against Birdie, though. Like, he's so far away. Why would I risk whiffing a DP?
I mean, you can get it most of the time. A lot of those jump-ins, he can jump in.
Yeah, they weren't at bad, good ranges. And then that EX chain he threw, you should have super punished that.
Yeah. I should have.
That would have been hype.
You're right.
I would not have done super punish there.
Yeah.
If I was a really good Ryu player, I would do this. But fun fact, I'm not a really good Ryu player. So.
Yeah, no, I knew he was going to medium kick, and I was trying to crush counter it with roundhouse, but...
Oh, yeah.
Maybe the only time in your entire life that you stand fierce in a crush counter opportunity might have been worth
it. Yeah. Maybe because you... Can you do stand fierce in a super?
You can do stand fierce.
Yeah.
You can do stand fierce in general anyway.
Oh, well, yeah. Stand fierce is also super cancelable.
Is it that weird old just... punch right there that
yeah
it's weird.
Actually, you don't even have to cancel it if you get crush counter.
You can just wait. Yeah, delay it. All right, so like I said, we are gonna see Birdie and Ken.
What's up? Okay.
Round one. Dude, I've been playing so much Injustice, it's so fun. Yo, Aquaman the god.
That game was fun. Like, it just sucks that it wasn't balanced.
Yeah, dude, and walk speed just makes me bang my head against my desk when I play that game because I walk so slow.
Yeah.
So good conversion there. Watson Chen's not playing.
Mm-mm,
Fire
yeah.
Team.
This is Robbie.
You gotta change the name to Robbie.
Oh, he has enough to do. Okay.
Right, so there we go.
Okay, this is Robbie was just saying earlier he thinks this is a favorable matchup for Ken. I actually think the opposite. I think Birdie's pretty hard for Ken.
Birdie does a really good job of controlling ranges that Ken wants to be in.
Yeah.
With that stand medium kick. So, that chain.
And like, Robbie's always kind of had a mental block against grapplers.
Yeah. There's definitely a big one that you have to get over. Oh, no. No punish on that target combo. Your first time playing, like my first time playing Street Fighter and dealing with grappling characters has not been fun so far.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, grapplers are a lot more honest in this game, though, to be fair.
Yeah.
Ooh. No more two-frame command grabs.
Yeah, for sure. All right, very nice conversion there from Robbie V. He has to get something started. You got to watch out for that armor. He tried it and got meatied.
Yeah, drop the combo
there. Cross up Tatsu. Medium kick Tatsu is going to play a big role in this matchup, considering that he's going to go for that medium punch anti-air a lot of the time, and medium kick Tatsu is going to beat it most of the time. Wow, just does it. Very nice whiff punish there from Robbie. As he evens up in rounds.
Final round.
Alright. So, we got the can coming out. Not quite a punish from Robbie, but beats him out in the air.
There we go, like I said, that medium kick Tatsu.
Yeah, very hard for characters without invincible anti-airs to deal with.
Robbie's getting away with these target combos. They're super negative on block. Oh, nice punish there.
Yeah. Can super not a ton of damage, but can I build on this comfortable life lead?
Yeah, for sure. Especially when it's for the game, for the set.
Ooh, nice sweet punish.
I'm sorry, for the game, not for the set. That DP back there just building up some meter. Uh-huh. Beat.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah, Robbie not with the correct punish. Still no anti-air from Thor.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
Dolphin dive.
Gonna put it pretty close now, just from one command grab.
That back medium punch is stuffing that dolphin slide that he keeps on trying to do.
Yeah.
He's done it more than once.
So, yeah, the end of that round there, basically, worst behavior lost it because of his lack of anti-air.
Yeah, for
Robbie
sure.
Robbie jumped twice there, and the second time opened him up and took the round.
Did you go play Chody
Chobin? Oh, yeah, sure.
Chody.
All right. I'm actually going to step off to go play Chody Chobin.
Right.
Sorry to run mid-set, but we're trying to get out of here on time.
Yeah. Good luck, man. All right. Joining me, I got the Birdie, Ziggod. He got out from Overwatch for a little bit. Fokri.
Oh, hey.
Oh, dude, what's up, Fokra?
All right, Birdie's in a tight spot right now.
Yeah, for sure. We've been talking about how he's been missing his anti-airs and how Robbie's been getting so much off of him.
No.
Yep, and I was saying how that medium kick Tatsu is going to play such a big part in this matchup because, what is it, crouch medium punches the anti-air?
Mm-hmm.
Medium kick Tatsu is going to beat it most of the time.
Yeah, when I was playing casual with Watson, he was playing Ken a lot, and that was an approach.
Yeah.
There's little specific timing, and it can trade decently, but... Ooh.
Yeah, Robbie's doing a very good job right now controlling the pace of this match. He's not letting Birdie... worst behavior get away with too much. And he's just keeping him cornered. Very nice armor there. Nothing off of it. No. That was Robbie.
So cute.
Robbie. But like you said, Ken Super doesn't do that much damage. So, worst behavior not out of it yet. There it is.
Where?
B-trigger.
Okay, yep.
Regular.
Yeah. Okay. He's still definitely in a one combo.
Oh, that's the game.
Oh, yep. Okay.
Easy confirm. All right, guys. I'm going to go play my game. I'll be back.
Good luck, dude.
Stay tuned. I got to go deal with fucking Mika, dude.
Fine? Oh. Yeah, you'll be fine.
Gonna take you for a ride.
Just play a solid neutral game.
I got to stretch my rock, paper, scissors.
Just throw rock all the time. Don't worry about it.
Oh, yeah, you're right. You're
rock
right.
Always wins.
All right. So I'll catch you guys later.
It's a good thing I play solely on
special Martin. Thanks to RTY hanging out in commentary. Oh, look at this throne over here.
Right, you don't have an armrest, but you got like the little regal.
It's not, a, it's it doesn't, and make sure Tyrannosaurus Rex.
You don't fall left.
I feel like a Tyrannosaurus Rex right now, or maybe a raptor.
Yeah.
Hey, can you switch the camera over here?
You look way more raptor right now.
I kind of look like a raptor over here in this chair. Yo, fire team. Can we need a visual. Commentary? I feel like a raptor right now.
He's got little,
little nut. Like, he's can't good. Really. Hard to play. I can play fighting games.
I have full armrests, as you can see. Actually, you can't see, but
it's funny because so usually we always have commentary for Top of the Shop, but we've never had a light, so it's always super dark. And now everybody for some reason is sitting way over there. They're like sitting way over there, away from the commentary. Yeah. Night the shop goes. Do you want to get on the house, my Martin? All right, so Jesse Ruby.
All right.
Yeah, I guess so.
This match is going to be so fun, nuts. Whichever way it goes, because RTY's pretty animated when it comes to
all right, I like it.
To things going or not going his way.
What's up?
Yeah, karaoke's tonight.
Right yeah, now? They told I was told that the karaoke was done here.
Really got, like,
but I'm getting wrecked. So anyway, Nikali and R. Mika. So our Rayshon talking a little bit about this matchup, how it's kind of so-so on how to use it. Now, what you're going to see here is, you're going to see a lot of the roll from Mika down forward, hard punch, because that is Jesse. You will not see Jesse
in specific.
Yeah, you will not I didn't say you will not be playing R. Mika. You will be playing the R. Mika, because Jesse embodies all of the chaos and all of the...
he really does. Look at that in between.
Just have this. This is all...
Is that a challenge? Or is it just guts?
You can't challenge it. Jesse never moves. Right. Jesse never walks forward.
Ooh, bop.
Fun fact. Huh. Watch out, he'll never walk forward.
What's the mix-up? Good DP.
Nice challenge. Wait for overhead, bop him on the head. All right. What Rayshon is going to have to watch out for is he does this thing where he activates and he'll waddle back and forth, and then he dashes in. He's going to mess up and catch a Mika roll.
He'll get a clap. Clap
roll. Yeah, or Irish Whip.
Yeah, we haven't seen too many claps from Just Rugi yet, but watch it happen.
Oh, look, it's button all the time.
Button, button, button. Dash in. Okay.
Never good break. Good break. Just Rugi needs to keep doing roll, because RTY has tried to challenge every single roll. There's a lot of counter hits going on.
Yep. Oh, good. Good conversion there. All right.
Damage?
No, nothing, but rolling in.
Oh,
keep rolling. Oh, no.
Yeah,
so
keep
close
rolling. Fred Durst, the Mika. Wow, I don't care about your activation. I got armor.
Oh my word.
Let
him
know.
And they're both sitting pretty good on meter.
R. Mika got through that round without using calling a Deshko, and that's interesting.
That was exceedingly rare. Oh,
I don't know what the peach was for. Jesserugi.
That was straight guts once again.
Yeah, he's telling me that he uses it to get over projectiles, wake up super. Oh, my Brandon Nutty is more nutty than your Brandon Nutty. How many fresh
nuts? You know, watch him do a wake up super.
Dash forward on the super.
Watch this. Wake up super.
I felt it. I felt it.
He's gonna
Fulcra,
do
it.
If I was RTY, I would be like, okay, I out nuttied him.
Yes.
And he wants to one up my nuttiness.
Yeah.
He's gonna
super.
But he can't really keep. You know, at that point, when you have that much life, just nut it out.
It's,
you know,
it's one of those things when you play a player who is this button active, like Just Rugi is. Meaties are so important because they are always going to wake up with a button. Kind of akin to playing a Ken player in 2011. They're going to wake up with hard punch DP, and if you block it, they're probably going to do hard punch DP again. So
nice little
expect that to happen.
All right, so instead of the more conservative approach, from R2Y. He's doing it. He's doing the damn thing.
It's just
thing.
A molly right Ooh. Now.
I think that was a command grab that got stuck.
Dude, it's like 4 for 4. Every roll is followed up by counter hits. And these aren't Ooh. These aren't meaty.
See, there's a trade. There's a trade. Yeah, immediately after roll. Ooh, button. Okay.
Excellent use of the reversal. He's in there, though, still. He's really close to stun. Wow, that anti-air reached out and touched somebody.
RTY was complacent with the trade after the roll. That just kept him in.
That was a complete shift of momentum. It was like going downhill in a spare pair of skis, and then somebody else shoots by you with a rocket-powered jetpack or something. I don't even know.
This is basically the most Looney Tunes version of Street Fighter V.
Yeah, I've got Porky Pig on deck right now for the commentary. Big cross-up damage by RTY. Wake up, EXP.
Yeah, he's not really respecting him in terms of wake up.
Yeah, another counter hit.
Here comes Nadeshko. Good. Okay. All right. I get it. I see what you're doing. He's saving it. Okay. Yeah.
It is a. I'm not gonna say it's not a coin flip. It's just whose train is trying to leave the station first.
Who's going to coin flip first and hardest? They're like in line for coin flipping.
Yeah.
There are two lines and they're meeting together. Okay. It's like only one of us can go in.
Right. Well, they flip the coin. Instead of letting it flip, they catch the coin halfway and slam it into the ground. And then they don't care about the heads and the tails.
They pull out another coin.
Sometimes it's a nickel. Sometimes it's a silver dollar.
It doesn't matter. Sometimes it's a pog.
Yeah. Slammer. So, Jessarugi right now trying to make something happen. Got to win one round to stay on winner's side here. Okay, guess?
Sort of getting out there, which isn't so bad. All right.
Big jump opportunity.
Okay.
Kept it simple.
Just enough. Jap. Ooh.
Nice throw break. Ooh. Look, just rolling. Come on.
Okay. Oh, he got counter that time.
Now, I know y'all be loving this right here. L-I-M-P. This kid is right here. People in the crowd. As far as I go.
That's about it. That's
if Cups was
enough.
Here, he could help me. Cups would help me. We had this Limp Bizkit barbershop quartet thing where it was like, ooh, break your face tonight. All right. Back into it. 1-1. Jessarugi trying to pull off an upset here.
And RTY might be a little bit slanted after that, but
hopefully not.
Hopefully not. He has composure, and Jesse has buttons. Very brave buttons.
This is the entire story of the match right here.
Oh, no jump?
If he gets him in the corner, it is done deal.
Yep.
Fire team, switch the scene. Oh, I'm sorry. Fire team blowing up my setup over there. That's okay. You guys got some face commentary. Sport does like
so yeah, that's solid. But as we've seen in previous rounds, Jesse can really sway it back the other way.
And right, good, what, good here's time. What we're seeing: yeah. RTY out of the corner with the Berserker Barrage. Fine.
He just
fine.
Needed that one every single time. I think Jesse has been landing those EX Peach Bombers.
Yep.
I don't think RTY's blocked one. Ooh, cute.
I really think that Jesse should just keep pressing buttons after the roll, because every single time it's been met with something else. Like,
it's technically minus, right? Well, it's spacing dependent, I believe.
Big damage. Okay, down to the match point here. All right, so if we're going by the coin flip mentality, now it's RTY's time to spike the coin.
I mean,
the ground.
This is basically they reach into their pockets. They both pull out just handfuls of coins.
Sometimes one pulls out a knife and just stabs the other person.
This is basically, yeah.
Oh my god.
It's like a Game & Watch in Melee.
Yeah.
Pull out a 9 for some reason.
Sometimes you pull out a turnip. Sometimes you get a frying pan or something. Peach pulls out.
You get a stitch face. Yeah.
Yeah, the big damaging one. She pulled out a sword at Evo, and I turned and I said, "What? I thought items were off."
All right.
Wow, he tried to challenge with the EX Peach right there.
I think that was misinput, or
one. No, Jesse cancel. Was going for the gold.
All right, just one more combo. Watch out for the. Here's the EX. No, he didn't do it. He didn't do the DP.
Oh my god!
What's gonna happen now? Is he gonna roll?
RTY, I really respect the patience.
He really needs to back off a little bit. Yeah, keep it simple, dude. All right. Ooh, that was a bit touch and go there. I would have thought my
heart
would have been racing regardless.
That was a thriller. A thrill ride of...
It really was.
New York Times says a thrill ride for the family.
The, are we playing? All right, we're playing. All right.
Who is it?
Me.
Oh, you and Sensei.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, special thanks to Fokra. Man, he even takes the headset off correctly. Fokra is a man of many talents. Joining me now on commentary is Mr. Rayshon.
Holy fucking shaking.
Hey, yeah, you got lucky, dude.
Dude, good I job. Got hella lucky, dog.
I know.
You see my DP reads?
Yeah, I saw them not get punished correctly once.
Yeah, my biggest regret in that set, last round, dog, and I V-triggered. And I should have saved it for V-reversal. But I got lucky. We avoided and how heated is he? Alright, look, Zev, look, last week you asked me how mad was I that I lost to Chad. The answer to that question is a 2, my dog. It is not a 6, my homie. It was a 2. Now, the weeks before when I played him, full 27 is the answer to your question. Definitely not a 6. I respect Chad. Chad, if you're watching, I don't respect you. Money match me, dog. This would be
perfect. Team Big Body on the way. If Kane Blue River could play a Marvel Street Fighter V game, it would be Alex, Birdie, and Zangief.
Yo.
I don't know in what order, though. I feel like Birdie would be a point character in Marvel if you were doing Team Big Body.
You're jaded on your opinion.
Or maybe he would have a chain assist.
I mean, you can go back and watch the views. I wasn't that salty. Yes, chain assist would be guy like in Marvel.
Chain assist and chop assist to put kill projectiles.
Yo, this boy is starting off nutty.
Yeah.
God, dude.
All right. Caffeine on the board. Nice. Kind of inadvertently adjusting the stage where you have to respect the can while it's on stage. And if you sit and block, Birdie can react accordingly and try to get a decent setup.
Yep.
If you walk yourself into the corner, well, you're in the corner.
Very nice command grab off of that banana slit. There's not too many options you could do it off of that banana slit, so...
It always puts the idea in the back of the opponent's pocket.
Very smart from Fokra to view reversal that. So obviously Fokra very familiar with characters, grappling-based characters and their setups.
It's more like I think Fokra is aware of how vulnerable Birdie is. We talked about this in the media setups and things like that.
Oh, yeah, sure.
So he's like, you know, I got a button that doesn't have to... I don't have to put up with this.
Yeah, for
I'm
sure.
I'm just going to view reversal it away. And he is confident in his ground game and his neutral that he can make the damage up where you would get the view reversal.
Yep.
Sneezing.
Yo, this fan is godlike right now.
It's pretty good.
Alright. Nice air to air there. He gets a power bomb right after it. Oh my god, needy power bomb. Wow, dude, that beat it. That beat armor, dog. Oh.
Wow.
That was reaction. Shout out.
What a freeze frame that is right there. He didn't headbutt him, he belly slammed him with his forehead. What is that?
Yeah.
When you try to go for the headbutt and you accidentally end up kissing the opponent's
belly button. Come here, girl.
Oh, man. What'd you find in there, Alex? What are you finding in that belly button?
Oh, shit. This is where you had them donuts at. Hey.
Kind of a... I'm not really sure how well Alex's stand jab anti-airs Birdie's medium kick.
Yeah, it's not... Wow.
Oh, grab the chop.
That was weird. It's definitely not a go-to in this matchup.
Hand's still on the screen, BT dub. Oh, now it's gone.
Yeah.
Ooh, the young overhead.
Yo, guys, I did the look up on how long banana's on the screen. It's like 275 frames, dog.
Why do they gotta do that? Why can't they tell me how many seconds?
Right.
You know, like, I feel like somebody's like, oh yeah, the banana's actually on the screen for 2 seconds. They go, excuse me, 270 frames.
I mean, you could do the math, right? So 60 frames,
yeah, yeah.
It's 60 frames per second. So
my point still stands.
60, 120, 180.
It's like 3.5.
Yeah. Four and a half. Yeah.
Just tell me 4.5 seconds. But when it comes to Fang, though, when it comes to Fang where he's like, yeah, it's 6 damage every 10 frames or something.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that makes a little bit more sense. Right now, Alex trying to put the work in on Birdie right now. Fokra up a match.
Yeah, so we discussed this earlier. When you get Birdie, these reactions. When you get Birdie in the corner, that's where you want him.
Yep.
And that's where you want to keep him. Ooh, very nice neutral jump there.
Excellent chase.
So that's interesting to note, guys. Power bomb covers back roll and quick rise.
Yep.
So
That's very interesting to know.
That's the key word too, is the word covers, because you want to try to figure out the options your opponent is trying to use defensively.
Yeah, that does both.
And how do you beat it?
So for like Nicali, you see me do standby kick all the time. That's cover. It covers both.
Big damage incoming. Not enough time for the armor.
That's negative.
No.
Ooh. What?
Had he waited a frame later, he would have got the. Wow. All
right.
So just like in Street Fighter 4, an EX dash punch from Balrog, it's got armor on it, yes. It does more damage, yes, but it can be thrown.
Yeah.
So most moves in Street Fighter history that have a charge on the way in, that move really, move across the screen, you usually can throw them.
Yeah.
Barring Makoto and Yun, because those are strikes. Those are like active hitboxes. Because what happens is he doesn't actually start his hitbox like as close to you. It's a proximity thing.
Yeah.
Proximity thing. All right. Looking for it.
There's that stand jab we were talking about earlier. It works on that, but if he does jump in medium punch, I don't think it will work too much.
Right, because it changes. That jump medium punch by Birdie physically changes these hitbox properties. He becomes like a log instead of a...
Yeah, he's literally a baseball bat. And stand jab is just a 105 miles per hour baseball that you're not going to hit. Meaty. Oh, he goes for the... what that was, and he told this to me earlier because he tried it on me. That was actually a reset that he went for, and it whiffed.
Oh, wow. I don't know.
Ooh, Fokra.
That was a very big scramble situation right there,
for sure.
And it just came out in Fokra's favor. Go ahead and finish your thought.
I forgot it.
Oh, off to the media. I was going to say, most of the time, Sensei Guy opts, after he gets the crush counter, he just goes for sweep.
Oh, yeah, no. Oh, okay, that's what we were talking about. Yeah, so it's just a standing reset, basically.
Oh, okay.
Nothing too much.
Wow.
Powerbomb.
Wow. Where's the trampoline? The trampoline? Both players smiling over there. You can't see it. Both players are smiling over there.
I didn't know we put that on the stage.
Boing, boing, boing.
Punish.
Dude, they don't skip leg day. Gets out of danger.
Oh, you went for the sweet punish? I would have liked to see a powder. Powder bomb.
Hyper bomb.
Wow, he pressed the button after that.
Come here, you fat bazoonga.
Wow. Cool shot. Too late. No punish. Yep. So this game is not really based on tight links like 4, but it's definitely based on distance. So make sure you know your distance on your combos.
Yep. Yeah, not even so much if they're standing or crouching, but just...
Yep, just distance. Know when you're out of range for it.
Wow, both players trying to do each other the dirty right now.
Yeah,
40
sure.
seconds, Birdie's got a huge life lead right now. He's going to try to wear the clock out because this is match point, by the way.
Yep, and Alex with no meter.
Okay,
there's that one bar, and it's gone.
30 seconds, still has plenty of time for Alex to do that.
Nice air to air. Banana.
Look at this defense by Fokra.
Oh, the banana.
What? What?
There we go, guys. That was only frame 68.
Right.
In which
right.
Out of 275.
You're right.
That is why that banana worked.
Wow, he swept through him for the punish and found a banana instead. That? Wacky. That's wacky.
Are we doing winners still? Or you want to call some losers?
Well, I think me and Watson need to play actually winner side.
Is it you and Watson? It's me and you, Doug.
No. I think it's me and Watson.
No, it's me and you.
Oh, okay. So it's me and you now then.
Okay.
I'm in like the throne right now. What's up, guys? All right, so we got RTY versus Robbie V, Nicali versus Ken, a matchup that RTY is not super fond of. He's been pretty vocal about that in the past.
Oh my word.
Dude, I'm like in the throne over here.
Right? It's like, this chair is nice. All right, so RTY and Robbie, all right. Nice match coming right up here.
Yeah.
What's the bracket looking like? Okay. Lovely.
So this will be an interesting set. These players, I feel like, they're like polar opposites in terms of play style.
RTY is very like optimal, always wants the max damage punish, mm-hmm. wants the like optimal answer in every situation, whereas Robbie's like more of a, he has some of that, but he's like more of an intuitive player than anything.
Oh, totally. Yeah, when he has this pattern of reads going on, that's, I mean, they both have solid read game, but
yeah, I would say so.
This is a very interesting Venn diagram, I think, because mm-hmm. they share a lot of similar. What's that mean? Anyways,
RTY is teasing the Nash pair.
Was Nikolikin bad?
I don't think so either. RTY thinks so.
Okay.
But you know, he's a.
Well, oh, I see. He's looking at his phone. He is checking frame data.
Yeah. But yeah, he's definitely one of those players that suffers from the syndrome of underrating their character.
Oh. as a lot of us know.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I wouldn't be playing Ryu if I didn't think he was the best character in the game.
Fair. Fair. That's why a lot of people play Ryu.
Yeah.
All right, getting started.
Okay.
Whoa, both blue boys.
Yeah. Oh, okay, gets him with the ground pound. Nice frame trap from Robbie, but RTY not fighting. Yeah, drops the punish on that. No, gotta do stand jab for that combo to work. Gonna get a ton of damage for it.
Pretty much. Wow. Down to 45% just like that, but cornered.
Nice there. Ooh, yeah, fireball's gonna be.
I'm really interested to see how much Robbie respects the wake up DP game.
Yeah. RTY really doesn't wake up DP that much. He has to get very frustrated before he'll start using wake up DP, I've noticed. So as long as he maintains his composure, you probably won't see it that much. Mm-hmm.
Robbie with full bar. Can take the early lead if he wants to.
Wow, got the cross.
Yeah, good block on that. RTY on point with those ground pounds in around the fireball. Okay, good pressure to spin the meter, why not?
Yeah. Yeah, I feel like spinning meter for plus frames is almost always worth it. Got the wake up DP.
Yeah, you always want to keep it your turn.
Man. Oh, no, I don't mean to get off track, but that's one of the things that I hate the most about this game, is how, like, you successfully neutral jump to bait a throw, and then they anti-air jab you. It's, like, so defeating.
Well, that happens mostly with Nikali and Ryu.
Yeah.
Yep, that tiny little three-frame elbow. Or Sim, too, I guess.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah, he does have a...
Yeah, so we'll see if Robbie catches on and shies away from the neutral jumping a little bit.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, jumping in general.
Yeah, I want to see him stay on the ground more, for sure. He has a really strong ground game, so I don't know why he's so committed to jumping.
Yeah, and he hasn't been toying around with... Ooh, yeah, there's a side switch.
It's going to do huge damage.
Yeah, Robbie not doing the run cancels.
Yeah.
Oh, no. I feel like if I were a play Ken...
Stay on the ground!
If I were a play Ken, I would always test my opponent's limits with run cancels I can get away with.
Yeah, definitely.
That's just me, though.
I agree, because especially, I don't know if you...
8 frames notwithstanding.
Yeah.
Just round one. In fighting games.
Right. Well, also, not only is 8 frames a factor, but Ken's normals actually suffer, well, I say suffer.
they have more hit stun, or?
They have less hit stop than everything else. So when Ken does something unsafe, you have to buffer your punish earlier than you would for anyone else.
Okay.
And so that's like why a lot of people get blown up by the run cancels, because they don't compensate for the lack of hit stop.
That is maybe the 4th wake up jab into V trigger RTY has gotten. Nice. Challenging in that space. Bobbing in now, it's like, you want a DP? The throw.
I would have liked to see him spin DX Fireball to make it safe.
Yeah. Alright.
No punish on the sweep.
definitely could have reversed a super, maybe even reversal heavy uppercut.
Yeah, and at this point, he really has to use his meter to stay in it.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, exactly, yeah, right there.
It's worth it. Spent two bars, but worth it because he's still in it.
Round two. I feel like this is when the match can really tilt one way.
Yeah, for sure.
Punish.
Let's see if he gets... Yeah, I got the punish that time. Want to see Tatsu next time, though, for sure.
Just raw Tatsu?
Tatsu after the target combo.
Right.
It does the same damage, but it's more stun and corner carry than DP.
Okay, first command draw we've seen, maybe. Yeah, those jumps. He's getting a little bit antsy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Easy cancel. He could have... Is he going to be choosy about his super meter, though?
Let's see. All right. Both players can be triggered now.
Okay. Give him another one. Why not?
Oh, let's see if he gets the punish. Oh, drops it.
It's all right. Still. Oop. He just needs a couple more bops.
Yeah, very
one,
close.
One nice bop or two little bops? But Super's definitely going to take it for RTY.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's just... All right. Both. They should just both sit. Especially Robbie. Yeah. You have 30 seconds. That might be done.
Yeah, ooh, not quite going to kill.
Okay.
Let's go!
Everyone's popping up. Our team just stood up, mashing tech.
Both players popping off.
Staring them dead in the eyes.
Shut up.
Give them each other nice little hugs to let them know.
Yeah.
They are not going to take this to the parking lot.
Yeah, seriously. Challenge.
All right, so I think what just happened outside the game changed a whole lot what's going to happen inside the game.
Yeah, definitely.
I know it would for me. Yeah.
Nice anti-air.
Robbie's still not getting away with the jumps. I think he really, really wants a BP jump in combo, and he's not getting it. Ooh. Except for right there, it wasn't full beef. All right, good.
Nice tip. Ooh, he just goes for the damage and closes it out.
All right.
So Robbie almost always goes for the damage when he hits that. In that situation, it was great because it won him the round, and he's on match point now.
Mm.
But Ken can actually get a reset off of that Tatsu juggle.
What?
Yeah. So I really want to see Robbie start going for those resets.
Oh my god, he's so close to stun. What's going to happen next? Ooh, breaks.
Ooh,
just doing it.
Not respecting the pressure at all.
Oh no. No little jab there from Nicali. Okay.
Nice.
Bonking the overhead right there.
Yeah. Ooh. Messed up the uppercut.
Alright. Can Robbie regain momentum, or is RTY just gonna yonk it? I think he's gonna yonk it.
Yeah.
There was the yonk. Alright, last round.
Yeah, both players.
Meters basically even. But who's even in mentality? Final round. Or surpassing, rather.
Right. Well, Robbie definitely has the tournament experience advantage.
They are playing Walking in Memphis right now. Anyways.
Ooh, no punish on the sweep.
All right. Nice little DP.
Yeah.
Small chunk of damage. Yeah, good spacing on that sweep. Ooh, bop. Little bop. Oh, no, he's not. Yeah, he's just really catlike.
Oh, this is going to be big damage.
That is exactly what that boy needed.
Yeah. Would have liked to see him DP cancel into it, though, for even more damage. Oh, wow, he could have killed him there.
He needed a little tiny short in front of that. Give him a little bop. Just give him a little bop. There's the bop. That's all right, because that's still winner side.
Yeah.
Still winner side.
So we're going to see more from RTY.
RTY needs to just get some bloodlust going on. Work his way up. Fight Robbie again.
Yeah.
Robbie throwing his wallet straight to the stream matchup.
Yeah,
we might have ourselves a little bit of an exhibition tonight.
Yeah, maybe so.
Versus Watson Chan.
All right,
I'm gonna have to go play.
Good luck, dude. Woo! So.
Tar combo, the black. Yes, fireball. Got you in the game? I'm still fucking dumb.
They are playing Walking on this right now. Not a bad song, actually. So, how's everyone doing tonight? Press 1 if you're having a pretty good night. Press 2 if your night could be better. Press 3 if your night is complete garbage. And press 4 if you just want to go to bed right now and wake up in a week. The choice is yours. And yours alone. Nothing. I was just talking to the stream. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Oh, we got a fire team.
We'll probably get Robbie here on the mic here any second. What's up, Hurt Fox? Nice you're turning it.
All right. Having a good time. One.
We got one. We got ones across the board.
One is so good.
Ones
across. One for one. I am not going to Evo, unfortunately. Unless for some reason work can work it out.
Work it out?
Yeah. I would love to. I don't know what registration is like, but are we going in? Or are we going in right now? All right.
Okay, so let's see if Rayshawn can shake off the mental damage I inflicted upon him.
I know.
You rattled him.
You gave him a little bit of rattling. So he's.
I'm trying to fight the karaoke downstairs.
They're playing Walking in Memphis, though.
Yeah, it's good. It's a good song.
Anyways, this is going to be interesting in terms of RTY's mindset.
Yep.
He's like, how is he going to
bounce back?
Shoto's.
Sure. Well, a lot of Shoto players will agree that Mikali has all of the buttons, all of the tool set, all of the frames to fight Shoto's very well. Like, it's an uphill battle for Shoto's.
Yeah, totally.
Any Shoto that does Y, and we only have two so far, but Ryu definitely fights Mikali a lot easier than Ken in some more common circumstances as far as the neutral and the fireball game, anti-airs. Ken just got to do a little bit more BS.
As is the nature of Ken.
Sure, yeah, absolutely. He's got the Ryu is the honest player. Ken is the BS character.
Ken adds a little bit more fraudulence in there.
But classically, though, I believe RTY has taken this over Watson. It's always been close.
Okay.
It's always been close, but it's always come down to either Rayshawn drops a super or Watson just anti-airs don't come to play that day. Trying to use a Tatsu to get out of the corner.
About?
Man, I was on the other side of Nikali, and he was jabbing.
Grabs you the other way. It's like, no, you're still on the same side.
His dreadlocks have hitbox.
Is this, what's the most stun from there?
Ooh. He's going to find it there. Going to do an extra DP to build some meter.
Really feeling himself. See, he's not doing the jump in.
I think he's a little mentally fried still.
Maybe. Unless Watson was mashing out of that stun perfectly.
Could have been.
He could have got the jump, but...
Those are good trades.
Better safe than sorry.
Those are good trades. That's what part about what Nikali is so good is that, yeah, he has a projectile, but guess what? It doesn't interact with other projectiles. Wow. So that Tatsu right there, I believe Watson trying to take a book out of Daigo, doing a lot of point-blank Tatsus to blow up throw tag.
Blow up throws, yeah.
But, I mean, you got to be on like another
on paper,
read,
I love that. But, yeah, you really have to cycle through
Young. You got a lot of mileage out of it in Street Fighter 4 when you would walk up with Ryu and do the EX Tatsu when they're in the corner because there was no risk to it.
Yeah, what else is going to happen?
You got it right there. I mean, that was it.
All right, V-Trigger.
He's just going to fall in the corner.
So. Okay.
I mean, pretty much both of these players have a very solid offensive plan.
Mm-hmm.
And they're both committing to it 110%. Like I said, Rayshawn, has always been half a step ahead of Watson.
Okay.
Just in tournament play. These guys go back and forth all the time in casual. So at any point, Watson can, he can bust this out.
Oh, I believe it. Okay, nice. That's all he could get from there, I think.
Yeah, try to go for the Axiom rope-a-dope is what I call it. Not a ship, it's a rope-a-dope. It's 2-in-1. He does the dash forward, dash back, low forward, Ryu stuff. Oh, try to go with punish. Oh. Not in this game, my friend. No, sir.
Okay, interesting little trade there.
I would honestly be like, I don't know.
Great block for stun. But yeah, good block from RTY. No, okay, sweep for sweep.
Big
jab,
damage.
Jab. All right.
Time to guess.
Oh, is he going to? Yep.
Look.
As
sweep.
Much as
where's Watson sweep at? Stun.
Yeah. You know, that was super, super solid on RTY's part.
Usually in that circumstance, Watson always fishes for the sweep and to be trigger. It's the correct choice most of the time with Ryu. And I don't know if he really wants to prove something with those wake up tattoos, but sometimes you gotta abandon it. And I mean, that's gonna sound extra hypocritical coming from me. Have this DP. That was a DP, I promise. That was a reversal by Nicali. That was strange.
All right, what's going to happen here? What is this about? Everyone's just jumping everywhere.
One guy is an electrician, apparently. The other dude hasn't had a haircut. Okay, Street Fighter 4, or Street Fighter Basic. Look, he's looking for overhead right now. He wants to walk forward and get the overhead, and he's not going to get it. The super is going to kill. Rayshawn going to do like a quick 2-0 here. Oh, not enough. Shut my mouth.
No
overhead.
It worked.
Oh, my
right
God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I was already to pack it up. I already had the plane ticket bought. I was already on the train. Suitcases were already loaded up, and Rotson proved me wrong.
You were leaning halfway out the window, getting ready to wave to all of us.
Yeah, I was. My beloved was out there, was throwing roses, and I was like, this ship's not leaving harbor yet. I think I've covered every mode of transportation.
Segway.
Segway. You know, fun fact, we're at a train station. Okay, we're in there.
Okay, yeah, makes sense.
Oh, no.
And Watson is taking that momentum. One round, and he's just like, all right, now what? Now what are you going
to
do?
Perfect ranges. Watson is picking very good ranges to fight from right now.
Oh, no.
Three-frame jab.
Yeah, meteor solar plexus, very important. Look at all that damage just from that
sweep.
One little.
Looking for sweep.
Oh, please be reversed.
That's gonna be it.
Oh, the train is departing right now. He should have.
So Watson talking about how he wanted to save his meter there for the reversal. Yeah,
it happens. Watson bowing out graciously.
I feel like when players save the reversal in this game and they look back, that's always like the 2020s hindsight. When you're in the game, right. you're like, but I can get some damage here. But I can
Or you
get,
can stay alive.
Or yeah, or you
or
can stay
like
alive.
One or two other mix-ups.
Oh, thanks, dude. That's why I was complimenting your use of the reversal, because you're probably by now cognizant of the fact that Birdie has a little harder time with meaties. And it's like just keep, you know, but I had this fantastic function where I could just so get bad. You push you off of me.
Yeah, yeah. Especially versus Alex.
I don't want to mess with that. No, you want to hit that lariat and then be reversal right after that. That's how I take. That's my approach when I take to Laura and Armika with Ken. I look at it like I have three bars of beam trigger. I need to use these as a defensive mechanic, as opposed to the damage.
And you're more likely to get crush counters as well.
Oh no! Now they're screwing up my overlay.
Hey, Rayshawn did it.
Are you kidding
so
right now?
So Rayshawn doesn't beat me in Street Fighter, but he messes up my stream production. It's a good play. It's a power play. As Kyle Brockman would say, it's a power play. So okay. I respect
him. All right.
Speaking of power plays, now we've got another birdie matchup for Carlton Banks.
All right. Filthy clam trap.
So that comes from a joke. I have a character in my stand-up comedy called Raunchy Cammy.
You're just now telling me about your stand-up routine?
It's only one character.
Okay, that's fair.
I go, it's Raunchy Cammy goes to the White House, and it's like, I'm Raunchy Cammy. And then it's like, no, she's at the supermarket. Again, I'm Raunchy Cammy. But anyway, she's like a beat-up old maid from like the World War II era that used to service troops and serve really...
I gotcha.
Yeah, you guys can stick around for the after hours for that. So,
all right, good read on the command throw.
This is as aggressive I've ever seen Carlton Banks, aka Sensei Guys. Alex, ever.
Yeah, normally he plays pretty smart and spaces it out well, but.
I think it's because he's just very good at picking up tendencies, and he goes, look, if this guy's not going to anti me, I'm going to keep jumping, which is what you should always do
by
in Street Fighter.
Yeah. When the first round we played, he went for a headbutt. First thing he did, jab him out of it. Never did it again.
Dude, he was making some money off the V-trigger punishes, though. I was very impressed how fast Alex got across the screen. Oh, looking for a DP there.
No. Oh, okay, yeah.
Wow, that was almost.
You cannot challenge Carlton Banks with those.
I would do it again. If I'm Thor right now, I would go for another Dolphin.
Oh.
Whoa, he broke his hand.
That was
He went to chomp and he said, no, you know how thick my skull is?
We'll smash that. No, he hit it with the tip of his hair.
Right, yeah, no, that's the...
That was
what
wild.
Can I get you? What can I get you? Just give me that real headbutt head haircut. Say no more, fam. Say no more. I need it to be a... I need my haircut to go off at airport security.
What I've seen Thor do is he loves, like, and it's good for damage. He does crouch mid into medium headbutt.
Okay.
Doesn't have the range. He missed a punish there because of it.
Oh, I see, I see. Ooh, going air to air there.
Okay.
There's a great
cranking his hand up.
There was a great thread on our Street Fighter on Reddit that said, "What do you hate most about Street Fighter V?" And you know, people are talking about A-frames, lag, jab, blah blah. This one Dalsin player gets on. He's like, "I hate that every Alex player always feels the need to taunt me in every match. I understand I'm a new player and you're beating me up, but why do you have to taunt me?" And somebody's like, "Is he doing the wind up thing?" He goes, "Yeah, that's a taunt." And he goes, No,
that's a mechanic.
It's a mechanic, and he goes, "All right, I take it back. Whatever everything bad I said about Alex." It's just kind of funny. He was like a paragraph long of like bad sportsmanship. This.
Yeah, he knew wake ups. All
right,
that's pretty funny though.
Yeah, it was all right.
Doesn't play a lot of third strike.
No,
I guess a lot of new players haven't played third strike.
Which is fine. All right, so four. I would like to see crouch medium punch, anti-air. That is just crouch medium punch.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, crouch medium punch.
Yeah, just to try to keep Sensei Guy a little bit more honest. Now, Sensei Guy's got a great ground game. It's already proven that. Oh, but if you keep him out of the air, he's got to work that much harder to move forward. And these are just free opportunities you're getting in.
Okay, Tech, what's next? Meaty. Ooh, doubles. Man throw coming up soon? No.
Big meaties.
Yeah, big old.
He knows Thor's trying to press button between those block strings.
Oh, he thought that killed. Okay.
Big overhand chop.
Yeah. Thor needs to mid range? Throw out a jet.
Okay.
His dash isn't gonna do anything? Yeah. Ooh, from get go.
I mean, this is just basic Street Fighter fundamentals. If somebody's gonna jump at you, you absolutely They're just gonna get in for free, and they have every
the read.
They have every range. A little bit of a panic mode here. Gonna get some more damage.
Good reset.
Yeah, that was a reset.
That was gross. That was so cute. All right.
So I mean, if I'm Thor, and because like I got my ass handed to me last week by Sensei Guy. I'm not gonna be upset about that. You can go back and watch it and try to figure out exactly what you need to do better. Build a plan and come back next week. That's really all you can do, and that's one of the best things about coming out to weekly Street Fighter tournaments is, okay, you're not grinding at home for that LP, those league points, but you're gonna get better with the people around you.
Yeah, and definitely.
And also another benefit is you get your butt kicked by somebody. You can turn to that guy after the match is over and be like, "Hey, how do I beat this and that?" And, you know, this scene is generally going to be like, "Oh, well, I was just doing this, dude."
Very accommodating to your
friends. You got to do X and Y, man. You can't just...
Unless you're Rayshon, then Robbie
That's
will
Rayshon.
Poop all over you.
Oh! Whoa! He said it, man.
No. I wasn't talking about in the game. I was talking about, you know, people are like, "This seems really accommodating." And I'm like, "Unless you're Rayshon, then Robbie has." I was just telling Abby, I'm like, "Me and Robbie's relationship is weird." Like, to the outside eye, people would be like, "Wow, these two fuckers hate each other."
You just two are fighting each other all the time, dude.
I'm lurking right now, dude. I'm like a snake in the grass, a diabetic cobra, if you will. That's a sick name, dude. Diabetic cobra.
That's basically a Metal Gear Solid boss.
Oh, you're right.
Yep.
Big boss.
Diabetic cobra.
Diabetic cobra.
Diabetic fulcrum, what?
No, solid snake.
Cobra.
Oh, it said fulcrum. I'm like, what?
No,
like,
watashi no diabetic cobra.
Round one.
All right, so I want to see the hunger, no bad Street Fighter puns and play from RTY.
Well,
just so he can play you again.
He got a great start with that anti-air. And as we talked about in Thor's matches, he just jumping around all the time and setting that that precedence very early that, hey man, the skies are not free, is going to definitely force Carlton Banks to change up his game plan a little bit.
Yep. Okay.
Oh no.
Big punish.
Oh,
okay.
Throw punish. It's all right. That dive kick.
Oh, what?
Dive kicks are the natural anti-air blower-upper fixer-upper. Whoa! Whiffed.
Done yet.
Okay.
Oh, he did it.
Play with your heart.
He wanted V-trigger cancel right there.
Now the question is Macaulay?
What is he? Yeah, he's trying to bait the forward slash. Ooh.
The dive kick is absolutely one I want to go to. That's why I use Meaning Kitatsu so much to blow up the natural anti. Wow, finds low forward.
Was he trying to jump out, I think?
Yep.
Jump. I think he was thinking dash forward command grab this guy. Okay. So RTY. Pretty. Ooh.
Big damage.
Yeah, huge damage.
Alex might have one of the biggest meterless damages or DP punishes in the game. Mm-hmm. I think that was one of his big pros.
I would agree.
Whenever he was first released.
Yeah, that.
Ooh, this is where Sensei Guy is so dangerous. Like he beat me last week. He would just sit there and just sit there and just sit there and he walked into range.
He has no reason to go in with that likely. Right. But
oh yeah, absolutely.
No super. He's probably saving it for the kill, for lethal.
Yep, trying to top deck that lethal super here.
Yeah, excellent defense. Next grounded hit. Yeah, he knows Carlton is trying to jump out of it.
Ooh. Armored chop. Oh, might have been armored chop because you can throw him out of that startup frame. So RCY has been very strong all night. Once he gets you in the corner, it's maul time. Sensei Guy gonna have to change.
He's so good about mixing up his sequences too.
Yeah, absolutely. Sensei Guy gonna have to change up his approach a little bit as far as, because he was making a lot of money from the jump ins early on, and RTY is saying you cannot jump on me.
Or is he gonna get stonewalled a little bit more?
I like this right here. This is what you want to do. RTY's got to prove, how do I get in at this point?
Yeah, he's like, I will take some minuscule chip damage.
Yeah, pound the yard, and you get that chip damage back too.
Yeah.
So it's not like it's permanently
maybe
gone.
Maybe like 20 or 30 chip damage.
Well, this is very tit for tat. Yeah. This is the reverse zoning. This is not your daddy's zone that you put up in Street Fighter.
This is very slow zoning.
Nice. Big damage.
Yep. Okay, so he's gonna do all of this fun stuff and he's gonna sit back. Ooh.
He's got a read. He smells something in the water.
He's gonna get this. Bopped. Yep. Okay.
I'm all warmed up. This is not gonna kill.
For? Is it not?
Oh, he burned meter. I didn't think he was gonna burn meter.
He should. He needs it.
So, fun fact: whenever Alex has these all warmed up and he hits you, you see the crush counter animation. But he actually, the game registers it's a unique hit. It's called hard hit.
Hard hit, which is basically the same as a counter hit, or if it applies to a crush counter state.
Yeah.
Gives it to you.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, so if Alex basically just gets counter hit properties on all of his buttons after he gets all warmed up, and of course a counter hit heavy button is a crush counter.
Smart stuff from RTY, crouching.
Really trying to get this whiff punish game established here.
Oh,
wow! Look at
and,
me. I'm
the one of the shortcomings from Alex. Not a very good cross up. Word!
Hyper bomb. All right. My word, Master Fire Team.
This is pretty good. Pretty good stuff.
All right. So there was a couple little scramble situations that Rayshon got, came up tails on, just namely in the corner. Like there was a weird normal throw that RTY didn't necessarily think that should have quite happened.
Yeah, RTY's he's crouching, so he won't get hit by that towards Fierce. It's plus two on block.
Yes.
Relics.
Oh, excellent. Nice. Again, that dive kick changing the jump trajectory. Changing your jump trajectory is such a powerful tool in Street Fighter. All of it. Mm-hmm. Throws off the timing, throws off those hitboxes, finds a big jump in here, gonna go into trigger.
That works.
Keeps him in the corner.
No reset, wants the damage and corner placement.
Wow, that.
He got it that time.
I mean, what can you say about that?
No meter required. He didn't have any. But.
Yeah. What can you say about that? Sometimes you just knew he was gonna press the button. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right. So Carlton Banks on match point here. Right. This is loser side, so they will be done for the evening. Big damage.
Agree with the command grip. But.
Yeah. To be fair though, RTY hasn't been punished on that all night. Like on the neutral jumps, he's usually able to get a jab out
That's
afterwards.
True. That's true.
Here, he's going to work down in the corner. Needs to keep Alex here. Do not back him out too far.
Yeah. You can't jump in against. Alex, that his anti-air jab is pretty good.
These are reads right now. These are guesses, and they're all guessing right.
Yep, he's doing again. That should have been it. Okay, what's next?
Okay, all right, gonna put him at about 1%.
Yeah.
Maybe.
No, Alex health is a little bit lower. But
okay. All right. I was pretty close to 1%.
Okay, all right.
absolutely the correct answer right there with RTY charging in with that dash. Match point for both of these guys. It seemed like Carlton Banks had a little bit more of a dominated game, dominating performance in game two, but it's been very even the entire time.
Okay, look at that normal throw. He's like, I don't want to fully commit to command throw.
Oh, wow, trying to find a punish on this, we can't get it in time.
Ooh.
Too far away to get anything back. This is very tip for tap. Big damage coming in. Yeah. Ooh, Carlton Banks drops it, though. Good. Berserker Barrage to the corner.
Oh, can he keep him there, though?
Yeah, looks like he... RTY really trying to stand at the range. He's trying to say, this looks appealing to jump. You should jump here.
Well, you know, Carlton has not done EX reversal with his armor to get out at all, so he's just staying on him.
Oh, no. The hitbox changes just a little bit.
And at this,
still has a chance.
Man grab. Yep. He's going to do it again.
Still has a chance. Mashed out DP.
He did go for it again.
Man, he mashed out the DP hard that he stood up in his seat.
That was at least a 2.1 on the Richter scale.
He's a 16er though, to be fair.
This is What was safe?
You're playing Street Fighter V. Nobody's safe.
No one's safe.
You can't give it up. Go for broke. You gotta know what's coming, dude. All right, guys. So we're going to get winner's finals, which is
us.
Me and you.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll get some more fine voices on commentary over here in a second. Thank you so much for watching Top in the Shop here at Alamo Draft House. They host us every week. Give them show them some love on Facebook at Facebook.com/AlamoDraftHouseKC. Fantastic place to bring your family or a date for a movie and dinner. They got a restaurant and a fully stocked bar. So please come check Alamo Draft House out as well. They're also the home of Max Out. There will be no Max Out for July because there's another tournament going on in July. I'm talking, of course, about the Evolution World Finals 2016 in Las Vegas. So Kansas City will be traveling for that, so there will be no Max Out for July. Booker is going to step away, I believe, to go to the bathroom real quick. So I'm just going to hang out here on mic for a little bit with Fire Team.
What? Yo, that DP dog? He should have known. That's what he says.
I'll take that loss for you because he's so inspired by getting his ass whooped by me.
Yeah.
That he's got to get back there. If he would have beat me, he would never DP right there.
Yeah. I stand corrected, he says. Yo, and actually, this is rare footage of being actually able to hear Sensei Guy. Like, you can audibly hear him without guessing what he's saying.
I thought he was mashing B trigger and DP.
There's an option select.
Oh, it was an OS. It was OS. If he DPs...
You hate what? Yeah.
It's like it's Street Fighter 4 when you play against a Ken player, does, you know, hard punch DP, and then you go to punish it and they do another hard punch, or they do EX.
I mean, the whole concept, you whole life, you know, your best bet.
We can hear him.
To DP.
And go for the gusto?
Yeah.
Money on the line.
It's only like $20 on the line, TBH.
You know, I thought he was going DP right after when I
yo, no,
when I asked for ES command grab. I thought he was going DP, but he didn't.
Yeah.
So he woke up V trigger. And DP.
Dude, picture it.
I just did it, man. I'm pissed off.
Yo, this is godlike.
What's up, Zevran?
This is so godlike. We never get to see Mr. Blake on the mic.
That's crazy, though.
He's so tilted right now.
You want a DP. Robbie want a DP.
Yo, he just got told right here on the mic.
Robbie want a DP.
Yeah, you right.
Yeah, you want.
Yeah, you can all sit over there, dude.
Like, oh my god.
That's so awesome. Oh god. That's sick, dude. Man, you should. Oh, man. But yeah, that was... Sometimes, man, he's got to do it.
Bro, Nakali's a cheat. Every time when he did crouching meet him kick?
Yeah.
I tried to backdash out of it.
Yeah, I was say after. Yeah, all, yeah.
Jump
no,
back.
Yeah, I used to do that too. No, it's like true. It's a true gets. Yeah, it's like you do stand right house, V trigger cancel, crouch me and kick into the true block, or not block string, but like it catches anything you do. It's yeah. not. It's like a 2-frame trap or whatever. So you jump out of it and you just get wrecked.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what happened to me last week, actually. I used to backdash out of his stuff, and then he's like, stand roundhouse, V-trigger cancel, crouch me a kick.
Because he won a lot of games like that. He came back.
Actually, what he used to do is me, it was stand roundhouse, V-trigger cancel, stand roundhouse again. Because I was like, yo, dog, there's nothing you can do, right? And then it'd crush counter me, and then I'd die. You know you would have.
Right? Yeah, he would have. Hey, Rashawn, man, good shit. But you, next time, I'm looking out for it. You got one shot at it.
I'm just letting you know. So what happened was, reason why I DP'd
okay,
there.
Let's get the conversation going.
All right. So the reason why I DP'd there, right, is I saw the second frame of the startup of the move. And
bullshit. That was safe.
I was already on my 7th frame of V trigger, so I used the 8th frame for invulnerability on my 1-7 frames of DP, and it made sense,
no,
right?
No,
it was a mathematical DP, dog.
If I would just held block, I just put a block. Block. I didn't.
Like I said, I was either gonna win by that DP or I was gonna die by the DP.
So you rather die by it?
Yeah, man. I've been around Axiom too much, dog. You live by the DP, you die by the DP, dog.
Oh god.
They call me Steph Curry. They call me Steph Curry Jr. You live by the three, die by the three.
It's all right. You get one. You get one.
I'll take it. As long as it gets me in the money this time around, I'm all right.
That's all right.
You are confident this fight.
Yo, Xev, don't hate. It was a mathematical DP, dog. I told you. I just explained the math.
Xev.
Man,
it wasn't.
Nah, dude.
I should have just dashed a block.
Probably.
I should have. But I thought Rayshon would respect me that much.
Well, because I was respecting you the whole damn game. I did a couple DPs.
Not really. I had to literally kill a frame just to counter hit this guy. And he was like, wow, what a delay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course. Uh-oh. Well, we in the match now.
All right, so we got, Fokker and Robbie B. Winner's final series. This is a 3-5 set. We got that Birdie and Ken. We've seen this matchup a little bit earlier, in which Robbie took it, so just a different person this time around. Well, one thing we noticed about Fokker loves to V-reversal. Man, shenanigans, he loves to V-reversal off of jump-ins. So that's one thing Robbie should look out for. Maybe start grabbing after, like right there, see? Start grabbing after his jump-ins. Now that
DP
grab does so much.
See? DP. 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 If it was me, they would DP'd on me, bro. I swear to you. I swear they would DP. Nobody doesn't care about me, man.
Man, we love you.
Nobody cares about me. Nobody cares about me. They're like, you know what? I don't respect this guy. I'm DP'ing.
Well, okay, so if you know me, man, I'm a hard read player, dude. Come on now.
Man.
You know I will just hard read all day, regardless of what happened before. I don't
hard
care.
Hard hit. I see, that's wrong. See, Zebra, that was wrong with youngins. You know, they hard to listen.
Oh, that should be the game.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, command grab does so much damage.
Yeah. Alex up one. Robbie's on tilt right now. He can't let that happen.
Yeah, like we said earlier, it's the best, the first to win three. So Robbie has a little bit of time to adapt to this one.
Round one. Fight.
All right. Start off that forward heavy punch there from Fokker. He used the arm at the beginning. Yeah, not DPing the jump-ins there. We talked about this earlier. You have to DP the jump-ins for Birdie. And can't really jump a little bit too much because his anti-air is just almost as good as a jab anti-air. Oh, yeah, that jump right there, very bad.
You see that unblockable?
Mm.
It's unblockable right there.
Wow, didn't get the combo off that.
Jimmy time.
Yep. Mmm, nice. Frame kill setup. Mmm, yep. Oh, Robbie dropped the combo.
That's good.
And he shouts, what the fuck is wrong with this goddamn stick? He did say to me during our match he was having stick malfunctions. So, that's the thing. So Ness Native, let me check, because I'm pretty sure at the very minimum, Robbie could get a DP punish there. Let me check for sure.
Against this matchup, I think he's got to be a little bit more aggressive towards Birdie.
So that forward heavy punch, that one-hit armored move, Robbie could get a heavy DP punish on that. 4 frames, that move is -7. I'm pretty sure he could DP there too, but like that hit stun is so weird that you don't want to do anything off of it. Nice jump in. No damage. I wonder if it was his stick, because you see he was walking back right there. After he did the jump in, could have been a stick.
Oh no. I think if Robbie loses, he's gonna trash the stick.
Oh, big jump in. That should have been the round. Oh yeah, he doesn't like the stick he uses. You hear him say it all the time, he wants his fighting edge back.
He may trash the stick after he's done.
That was a punish, man. That was a punish.
No, I'm saying if Robbie loses, he may trash the stick. He may. I think so.
It depends if the DP comes out or not. Like, if the DP doesn't come out, yeah, he's gonna trash it. There you go. So I think he's starting to realize that Fokker's having a tough time. Nice neutral jump. No punish, but...
And see, that's the thing about Fokker. You know, on wake up, he likes to use EX a lot.
Oh, yeah. If he has meter, you gotta be prepared for it.
I mean...
Wow, what is this?
All you just gotta do is medium. Pretty much.
Yeah. But, ooh, nice.
But look, if his opponents don't know it's coming, bro, keep using it. Robbie got to learn to adapt to things. I'm sure he will.
Yep. So this... Oh, Robbie. I wonder if he could have, like, V-triggered to punish that. Maybe not, but it's possible.
Oh, they're going to set up.
Robbie's not out of it yet, though.
Oh, no. He's still sitting on...
Nope, it just takes one combo. Nice. Oh, nice. Tatsu over that can't... Oh, that's it. Nope. Next hit. Stipukiku, not there.
Back up.
If you just did a regular jump in, it would have worked.
Oh, nice.
Alright, hold on. Give me 1 second, guys.
Nice. Can win. No coaching. They banned coaching and evil, man. No coaching, bro.
Round one.
They're really serious about that. I'm right.
Oh, yeah.
In Combo Breaker, it was in game. In between rounds, in game, no coaching. But, like, after that game, you could take a break and coach. But, yeah, they were pretty strict on it.
I mean, technically, I don't.
I mean, I don't care.
Coaching don't really do anything.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
Because I'm not going to listen to the person.
But that's you. Like, the advice I just gave Robbie, watch, he's going to win the set, dog. He's going to win the whole tournament.
Yeah, he probably will.
You know what I told him?
He
said believe in the DP, dog.
That's bad advice, bro.
Really? I won.
Praise me to the DP.
When I go home, I pray to the DP. You don't understand.
Hey, man. You hear this guy?
I have a Bible.
You hear this guy? He was like... I won. Oh, really? Okay.
I have a Bible.
I can hold an L pretty good.
That has Dragon Punch. Yeah.
You know, think about me.
I'm not going to lie. If I lost, I was leaving.
Fight. I was going to leave, but that's not me. Even though I got to work in the morning. A nice style by Robbie Woody.
Very nice. He stuffs that. He has to be careful to trying to stuff that, though, because the armor, if he mistimes it, he's going to get hit.
Exactly. What's he throwing on here?
Dude, that slide is -15, but the amount of hit stun it does, there's nothing to do.
Exactly.
Nice confirm into the corner. He needs to keep this pressure here. So what I told him is on jump-ins, you need to grab.
Yeah.
Because he's V-reversing every one of them.
Exactly.
And then, and I told him right there, you have the heavy DP. It's a legit punish.
Well, we're on both these plays. You know? Oh, that's a nice reaction.
Yeah. I don't know. In this game, Tatsu is just as bad as a DP, dog.
Yeah.
That three frame and...
I mean, to me, it's random as a DP. You know?
Yeah. I mean,
when Ken first came out, oh my God, CDJ was doing it on like Wake Up.
I mean, did you guys not see Watson Wake Up Tatsu when I'm about to?
Because he didn't want to get command grab.
It wasn't even a command grab. It was an overhead. Oh, there it goes.
DX.
That meaty. Yep, nice. That armor. Oh,
good chip.
Woo!
Good chip.
2-1 right now for Robbie. Yo, I just want to give a shout out real quick to Robbie V. All right, this dude.
Don't curse him.
Man. No. Even if he loses, right? These last 3 weeks has been a whole new Robbie in this game, dude. Pre-combo breaker, you weren't seeing Robbie V in winner's finals. This dude is grinding his way up, and he's been in top three these last 3 weeks. So shout out to that dude, man, for sure.
I got to give it to him.
Dude. Yeah, he's been putting a lot of work in.
He's got a secret dojo we don't know about.
Yeah, it's called the Glen Sun dojo.
He's training with somebody.
Yeah, he's Glen Sun.
Like we don't know.
Yeah.
But I know.
That's him. I mean, whatever he's doing with Glenn is definitely working. All right, there he goes. He's getting nice meaty. Yo, that meaty tricks me all the time too. I don't even blame Fokra, because I always think it's the fake. It's not.
Oh, I think Birdie, as a character, is kind of. He got a lot of damage and health, but I think he's kind of bad in a lot of.
Nice conversion there off the banana. He jumped right into it.
Yeah, that banana's cheap.
Yeah, dude. Oh, he's gonna slide right into it. Yep.
That's how I died.
Oh. If he could have saved that V trigger for that conversion there, that probably would have been close to the round. There has to be some kind of punish for these guys on chain. Maybe it has enough of a hitbox on recall for them to DP it. Maybe.
I think different chains would probably have
different properties and different frame data. Yeah, but.
So I mean, it's kind of hard.
Yeah.
Which one Alex is throwing? Unless it's the EX, one is super punished.
Yeah. Like you said, I wonder. If there's a DP punish around there somewhere. Nice. EX tosses to get out of the banana. Oh, flips.
Man, yeah. That banana pin, you could go and pop popcorn, come back, and it's still on the ground. I kid you not. Robbie, you could go and make popcorn, that thing's still on the ground, bro.
Yeah.
Well, it takes 2 minutes and 30. What, 2 minutes
and
30?
4.5 seconds, dude. It's
insane. All right, yeah.
Go down, you just like.
Gracious.
Yeah, no, okay, so it's 200, it's active for 200 frames.
Oh, so 200 frames is
60
seconds, yeah. 3.3 seconds.
Yeah, it's still ridiculously long. So.
See, this is a trick right here.
And if he gets hit, it should go away. That's
what I think.
Or if he, block. If he blocks, it should go away. It shouldn't be there for as long as it is. With no. Oh, nice jump in. He gets a nice sweep.
Oh, no dolphin dive.
Yeah, so one thing that Robbie should know, and I don't know if he has anything to cover this, but Fokra loves to back roll. And like I said, I don't know if Robbie has anything to cover that. Nice neutral back jump out of that punish. There we go. Robbie sitting on match point. This guy could go to grand finals. This isn't the Robbie V we saw.
Robbie is coming up in a win.
Yeah, this is Robbie V we saw week one of Top in the Shop when he got second place.
He's coming to win.
Yeah.
He's coming up.
For sure. Shout out to Casey Bennett. I mean, you and I both agreed that for a while it was going to take Casey a lot longer to get to where they need to be.
Yeah.
And I finally started to see people get to where.
I think if everybody practices hard, they could be the better.
Yeah, for sure.
The better.
Nice neutral jump. It's going to give Robbie a huge life lead. And he's close to stun. You got to watch. Oh, he went for the grab setup. I was expecting a step kick. Oh, nice. I wonder. Was an anti-air, but it seemed like it came kind of late, so. Yeah, don't worry about.
Beecher got it.
Yes, dash up throw. I was definitely out of range where he could do whatever he wanted to punish that.
Yeah.
It takes one confirm right now. Oh, that was it. That's the game. Oh, okay. Very close. Oh, that's the game. Robbie V has made it to grand finals. I'm going to go play my game. Yo, shout out to my boy, Robbie V, TKC, represent. Doing well in the grand finals.
Robbie, you did okay.
CR boys.
Robbie, you did okay.
He didn't believe in the DP enough though, so I'm actually thoroughly unimpressed.
See, you see Robbie, he don't live by the DP. He doesn't live by the DP. Robbie, see what happens when you don't have your Diet Coke?
Yeah, dude.
Exactly, man. Exactly. You cannot like the Royals without drinking a Pepsi, bro. We sponsor them. They sponsor by Pepsi, bro. So if you take a Coke to a Royals game, it's disrespect.
Yo, I can hop on the house mic.
I only drink Pepsi stuff. Like, there is few things that taste better on a hot day than a Mountain Dew that you get at a Royals game in that cup, in that plastic cup with that ice, man. Something about it, that makes it taste better. But, Rayshon and Folk are here in Losers Finals. This is a 3 out of 5 set. What time is it?
I don't know.
Currently 10:07.
10:07.
Yeah, we have a little bit.
Is this one mic 3?
Yeah, you're on mic 3.
I think this is going to be a crazy matchup.
So, Rayshon's entire offensive game has been very explosive all in the corner. Foker has been very good the whole tournament at being holding this range right here. This one square range is where he's really going to benefit. And again, Birdie outside of the V-trigger is not going to do a massive combo to burst you down. He's going to hit and chip away. Basically, if Chun-Li didn't have anything, could not convert off of a combo. That's kind of how Birdie's damage plan goes. That's where he's going to make damage. Those little hits like that, it's going to add up. And back with, what does he have, 1,100 health? He can take a little bit more of a beating than Chun-Li, too, in that respect.
Yeah.
Okra, RTY really trying to adopt his own game, just like I say that, finds a way in with command grab, armored in, more damage on the way. Not quite enough, or to hit a meter, I guess. No, he did have meter.
He dashed once, and I think it's safe on all 3 frames of work.
That is, yeah, that is an unfortunate, that's unfortunate right there. He missed the spacing on the dive. Is Sensei guys, is the audio looking okay?
Oh, no.
Give us a mic check real quick. Blake?
Hello?
Okay, that sounds better.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, now we can hear you. Yeah, again, let us know, guys. We got chat up at home. Let us know how it looks and kind of sounds. Right now, how it looks and how it sounds is Birdie in the corner trying to find a way out. Good anti-air. Didn't see a single crouch medium punch from you and Fokra set, and he started really blowing me up with him.
Yeah. I think Birdie should be able to stay in that range where Nikali can't get in.
Yeah, his stand medium kick and crouch medium punch especially really make it a hard time. Like that's where Birdie wants to try to fight. Yeah, a lot of people think that he's a grappler and he wants to be up in your face, but this range right here, that one half square range, not gonna be quite enough.
You gotta live by it around here in KC. You see, with Alex, I can't do nothing like that.
You got a armored chop though, right?
I get hit out of it.
That's why I kept pressuring him throw on wake up, because I was trying to blow up that EX dash punch.
I respect y'all too much for me to do that on wake up.
You go crazy, man. Is today gonna be the point where you like we start seeing Dark Sensei guy?
And no.
He starts just blowing us up, walk up DP kind of stuff.
No, I won't do that. You see, look at that grab every time. You see, after that he could have went for a frame trap. You try to condition your opponent. I mean, that's what I try to do.
He's so quiet. That's what
at least,
so
that's what I try to do.
I got. Well, I'll talk about the match right here. It looks like it's going to go RTY up 1-0, but I'll go back to that. So my problem is I don't commit to the game plan. I'll think I'm going to frame track this guy, and then the last second...
You back off.
I back off, but I actually follow through with it one time against Fokra. So if you're out there watching Glenn, I'm trying. But anyways, we're not talking... Not enough about me, more about RTY and Fokra. Again, this is a 1-3 set. Trying to stay in. We'll be playing me in Grand Finals. I like Rayshon doing a good job trying to check with that crouch medium punch, but Nikali is such a good button and it can convert into all kinds of damage off of it, similar to Evil Ryu's low forward.
Yep,
gets caught trying to
dash forward.
Chow some potassium. Man, the sequence.
Nikali is so good up close, man.
Yeah, he's got all the tools. 2 different 3 frame jabs. Big damage off hit confirms.
You see, yeah. I don't think Fokra caught what Rayshon doing on reset situations. He's DPing off a reaction.
Okay. See, that's the Rayshon special right there. He anti-airs you with the jab. He always walks forward and goes for the throw.
Exactly. It's kind of tricky, too, as well. It got me with it a couple times.
It's
well.
it's a pretty high risk situation for the defender. Like, what do you do? You reversal? Well, that's really easy to just hold back on.
Fokra, oh, let's see what happens.
Trying really hard here to keep that V reversal open to V to, for against the onslaught of RTY. RTY is sitting on a full super countdown.
Ooh, okay. That's where it comes from the collie. Dash up grab.
Dude, the dash is so good.
Oh, dash so range trap. That's so hard to see.
Yeah, it's very good. So far, Rayshawn making a lot of money off of the V skill.
As a Nash player, I will 100% endorse the godliness of V-Trigger Dash from the collie. Nash approved, dude.
Nash approved. We're talking, of course, about that delayed. My dash doesn't start until 8 frames, homie.
Oh, no super?
Looking for overhead, not against RTY. Answers back with the crash jab, trying to get out of the corner.
In that situation, you got to give Nikali his respect, especially if he's sitting on 4 meter and V-Trigger.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard. Ooh. Wow, okay, I got a little bit of a restand. I mean, this matchup just feels really hard for Birdie.
It is hard for Birdie. I think Birdie got to outplay Nikali in this matchup. Oh, look at that.
Okay, not going to kill him. Going to put him about 10%. Nikali is a damaged monster, though. Slightly more. Really surprised we didn't see any wake-up armor by Birdie there. I mean, really, just one hit.
He got grabbed
out of it. So again, an EX dash punch, always, you can always throw somebody out of it.
Or meaty.
Right. Because it's not invincible on frame one. All right, so RTY up 2-0 right now against Fokra, losers finals. So, I mean, as a Birdie player, you want to try to hold that. Oh man, just barely missed space. That's the second one that the idea was right. It was just slightly mistimed by Fokra, or missed space. It's hard to throw that button out right there because I believe Nikali's is probably faster, and it's just like you're just gonna put yourself in a crush counter scenario you don't want to be a part of.
Yeah, especially in that range because he can dash forward and combo after. Yeah. See, this is when the Kata get this game, man.
Yep, and really not much. I mean, if that's all you got to worry about is a wake-up short, you don't really have a whole lot to be worried about in that respect. Wow, Nikali got to the ground really fast on that.
Oh.
Also, I mean, the thing is Fokra really hasn't been put in a position to where he can train RTY to hold down back. Because usually, Fokra's Birdie makes up damage in footsies with sneaking in the command grab every once in a while. He hasn't been close enough the whole set. And when he is close enough, it's Nikali that's been on the offense.
I think Fokra need to start command, like doing tick grab setups with Birdie on wake up. Try to kill a couple frames and try to grab that crossing jab.
Okay. Hard to do against 3-frame jab though.
Yeah, you're right.
He have to be
meaty, very meaty.
Right. He'd have to definitely do his homework on that. All right, finds. This is where you sneak in damage as Birdie. Tries to go for a setup, gets met with crouched claws. Not enough for super. RTY holding on to it. Birdie finding himself in a. Oh no!
This big damage right here.
Yeah, this. Maybe 1%. Exactly 1%.
Exactly.
Ooh. Okay. So, I can imagine that Fokra will go into the lab and do a little homework on this Nikali matchup, this Nikali monster. So, all right, guys, coming up next, we have Grand Finals, myself and RTY for topping the shop this evening. Again, thank you so much for hanging out with us. Special shout-outs to Alamo Draft House here in KC, right in the heart of Kansas City on the edge of Power and Light. Come check them out. I also host Max Out. No Max Out for July because we have, that's an old, unupdated
hey, Alex. Alex.
Thing. So check them out, Facebook/ Kansas City or Alamo Draft House KC. So Grand Finals coming up next, guys. Thanks for watching.
What do you even edit that at here?
Commentator panel.
Yeah,
right
now. Yeah, and then it's like
lower one, lower two.
Yeah, it's like lower one would be whatever's name, and then the one lower two would be like a Twitter handle or something.
Oh,
that's why there's 4 slots.
Okay, I was like, what?
Yeah,
hey, Alex. You gotta start doing your tick grab setups, bro. You'd be so much dangerous.
Because then, once you start using that in your matches, they're going to start jumping, back jumping. You can probably chain.
Yeah, that's a hard read, though. That's a super hard read.
Yeah.
It could happen. It could happen.
Oh, no.
Who's giving me personal advice?
I was giving personal advice.
Fulcra, whatever you do in life, do it well.
This is true.
just straight up, like, literal life advice.
Yeah, man, you know, just be the best. Just be the best.
Right. You know, I tried.
At everything you do.
It wasn't there. That's a tough matchup.
Yeah, it is. It sucks. Super hard. It sucks when you get close to you.
I read the jump out of the corner there, and it's like, all right, he misses the first normal, gets the second one. Why not?
He's jabbed, right? He's jabbed right out there.
Yeah. It's all right. No, read my stuff pretty well. He's out of town, I think.
Yeah, he's out of town for today.
I'm going to smoke 3 cigarettes when I get home.
I'm gonna drink like 5 cans of Pepsi. And think about that wake-up DP.
Oh, my God.
That's going to hurt me in my sleep.
Yeah, I got hit by this. Yeah. Really, like 3 of those. That's all right.
You know, it may be gutsy, but when you play in the race line, on wake-up situation, you just back up and just do your little chain thing on wake-up.
Maybe.
It's gutsy.
Maybe.
I mean, because if he's going to jab, don't it beat low? Yeah, his little jumping grab.
If he does crouch jab?
Yeah.
Does it go over? It might beat it.
Like Alex Stone gun
him? Yeah, EX will...
Definitely.
It triggers higher.
Oh, okay.
Instead of, like... Because the regular ones actually require him to land first. I've thrown other birdies out of that, but so.
Round one.
All right, so the saltiest of run back. Well, maybe not even salty run back, but RTY is getting the second chance.
Exactly. Robbie won at that match, didn't
he? He did. He did.
See, they go a little bit of DP.
We'll
see.
Yeah, that's still getting pretty wild.
Oh,
stun. Is it stun?
He got it.
He got it either way. Why aren't they neutral jumping first? Yeah, save a bar, but yeah, that's just me nitpicking. I'd probably do the same thing.
He wanted the guaranteed kill. I don't blame him.
No.
I hate Nakali that much, too.
Nice jump in.
Oh, nice. Right.
Yeah.
See?
First game, he's going to pull out all the DPs. Is he going to do it again?
Oh, he didn't do it again?
He didn't do it again. Please jump. All right.
Oh, there we go. Big damage. What are you going to do? Don't wake up. Oh, you see?
Yeah. I got hit by that so many times as well. Wake up, Jam.
You got to watch out for it against the Nakali player.
Yeah. Robbie looking pretty good, but RTY trying to stay alive right now.
Exactly. I think Robbie, how he got caught with that low forward, he tried to back grab and jump.
He's going to wake up Tatsu. No, there's a split second wait right there.
Oh.
Okay, all right.
Wake up, me.
See a lot of kids do that, I feel.
Or jab. I probably would jab.
Oh, yeah.
I get off of me. Nakali's so
wake up, medium punch might have blown up the slight delay.
Yeah, you're right.
All right, dude. Cooling down a little bit. See what's going on next.
Round one. Fight.
All right, so toning it down a little bit.
Oh, that was real funny. Uh-oh, he's going to Nakali do it again.
Now it's...
Frame okay, jab
yeah, keeping him in there.
Ooh!
Oh, that was...
I guess I was
maybe missing, but yeah. All right, wake up jab once again.
Ooh, he stuffed your fireball. Close. This is when Nakali
flies a little bit. RTY with the... Alright. Ref of life still on Robbie right now. No stand jab on that one. Good DP.
We were looking at
it. Knew was going to happen.
RTY knew what's coming.
Yeah, first game was sort of everything all in.
Yeah. Both of the opponents filling each other out.
Oh,
he missed.
That's
That's unfortunate. Now Robbie's going back in the corner.
Both of them have been a little bit shaken up right now.
Yeah. Ooh. I can't say
this is the kind of Street Fighter I thoroughly enjoy, but I can understand the mindset.
Oh,
ooh, trade on the DP there.
Nobody DP. Oh, there we go.
Okay.
That was kind of punctual, isn't it? They're like,
it's a jab. Must be so nice to have a 3-frame jab. I can't even imagine. How much 2 extra frames seems to me is a world of difference. Man. Yeah, R2Y lifting Ken up. Nice and proud. All right. Robbie,
round one. Fight.
Very intent, very focused.
Oh, nice punch.
Okay. Yeah, Robbie doing the whole meter thing. I mean, not Robbie, R2Y. All right. Hey, couple neutral jumps in a row. Mm-hmm.
There's the shimmy.
He don't want to get caught by the command grab.
All right, forearm pressure again. Getting a stray counter hit from the neutral jump there. What's next for this matchup? Okay, cancels. Positive. All right. Getting a little bit of space. Getting a little extra damage off that white life.
Oh, nice.
Ooh, so many bops happened.
Robbie took that one.
So good.
I think both are players. They now are trying to adjust their playing style.
Ooh.
Yeah, nice DP.
Yeah, they're both getting a little bit antiquated.
Wake up DP is the name of the game.
So much more.
Oh, nice DP. DP. Let's go.
Alright. The R2 are a little bit late on the tech.
Oh, what?
Alright. I think, yeah. But that DP cost him the game. He can't close it up quite yet.
Oh, no.
I was wrong.
Wake up jab.
Scaling still there.
Oh.
All right, nice little reset. Next combo's gonna happen.
There go Nikali.
Ooh.
Gonna get to work.
So.
Nice DP.
Yeah.
Great shot. Slow down on the DP, brother.
Nah, Robbie's gonna take this 3-0. He's feeling it.
What's up,
bro? The peanut gallery. What's his just Jeremy on?
Just slow down on the DP, man.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, he really does. Yeah, that cost him a couple games. Which is alright, you know, it's...
Round one.
I want to wake up DP people.
You know, that would be nice. I don't have that.
I got to hold that.
I get thrown out of it.
Exactly. We got to hold that shit.
It's terrible. I want to get rid of all of my options. Alright, Tatsu's in. Stan Roundhouse just sort of whiffs. Alright.
I see checking in with them crouching medium kisses.
He really is. Ooh. Cool trade. Okay. I think he challenged the command throw right there. Alright. Does it again. Yeah. Robbie still with the life lead.
RTY is like 90% with the wake up jab.
Oh, no. It's a beat. Yeah. 95 even. Okay. Stepping in.
Oh. Nice good point from Robbie. Yeah.
Okay.
There we go.
There we go. Robbie's on point with the defensive DBs walking back, cranking them out. He is one round away. Might have been the quickest grand finals on top of the shot. But we'll see if RTY can bring that. A little bit stuck there. All right.
Oh.
He's giving him the run challenge right now.
Right.
It's like, all right, what are you going to do? Look at that.
What grab?
Good awareness from Avi, but here's some damage. Here's a little bit of V meter for Nikali. He's close. He's close to getting into big man mode. He's there. Where's the wake up
nice
jab?
Jimmy.
There we go.
There it is. 95.
Yeah.
96%. We missed the other one. Just about.
All right. One more beefy hit from RTY and saying it. But RTY's, I mean, Robbie's also so close. Oh my god, he's on support, right, all of his resources in it, but he can still. Yep, there it is. No more EX, no more little.
Oh my god.
Don't even. Did it. I would like, don't even do the overhead. But he did the overhead.
Man.
And he won. Robbie must be feeling pretty fancy right now.
Congratulations to Robbie.
Yeah, congrats. Bruno. Congrats to RTY as well.
Call dog.
Oh my god. That was RTY's dropping his set. Put your head back on, dude.
It's good games.
Yeah, good games. Very intense. All around.
That's it for topping the top for the
Yeah,
day, huh?
That was it. That was it. At the illustrious Alamo Draft House on Main Street, downtown Kansas City. Ooh. Ooh.
What if I grab a headset from one of the fine gentlemen?
There you go.
First place. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching Topping the Shop this evening. That concludes our tournament for this. We'll say evening twice. I don't give a shit. Let me get the score updated. You guys were following along at home. All right. First, I want to give a shout out to Fire Team running the stream all night. Did not enter bracket this evening. Also, special thanks to Watson, RTY, Fokra, and Sensei Guy holding down the mics, keeping you guys entertained at home. Shout out to Zevran, Gamer Champ, Madaw83. Let's see, who else we got in chat here hanging out with us this evening?
Yeah,
Vegas.
What I need to do if I do
Young Brad Wynan,
like jump in.
Twisted JB. So thank you guys for hanging out with us this evening. Again, broadcasting tonight from Alamo Draft House. So here is your top eight. Only 13 guys tonight, but trying to keep Street Fighter V going as hard as we can here in KC. Hopefully I didn't just turn myself all the way down. So anyway, without further ado, here's your top eight. First place, myself, Robbie V. Second place, RTY. Third place, Fokra. Fourth place, Carlton Banks, aka Lone Wolf, aka Sensei Guy, aka Blake, aka Trey. Fifth place, Watson Chan. Sixth place, Filthy Clam Trap. Seventh place, Jessa Ruby. And eighth place, to Bold Boy. So again, guys, you can hit exclamation point bracket, find that challenge link, see for yourself how what the shakedown was. We've got till 11:30 here tonight, so we'll get some more casuals on stream. We'll get the salty run back, so on and so forth. If you guys are interested in more Midwest Street Fighter V action, subscribe or favorite the channel. You'll be notified every time we go live. Also have a YouTube over at YouTube/team_KC is where most of these archives go up on that afterwards. So whatever you guys want to get involved with, that's perfectly fine. We appreciate you guys hanging out with us nonetheless. So I'm going to cut the stream for archive purposes, and we'll get some casuals going. And remember, guys, the worst thing you can do when it comes to a fighting game is never pick up a controller. I'm Robbie Votaw. We'll see you guys next week.